Pacers Stadium in Corvallis. It's all decked out for college football on the final weekend of summer. Two games under Dennis Erickson. Two wins for Oregon State football. Two 100-yard-plus performances for Kent Simonton. Now, home game number two for the Beavers brings a new challenge. Georgia Southern, the Eagles, a second to none in 1-2-way with their precision option attack. Another beautiful day in Corvallis, Oregon, where enthusiasm for the Oregon State University football team continues to grow. And why not? The Beavers will be trying for their 10th consecutive win over a non-conference opponent. And if they can get by Georgia Southern, the Beavers will be 3-0 after the first month of the season. Hi, everybody. Scott Lynn along with Steve Priest, and there should be another big crowd here in Corvallis today as the Beavers take on the top-ranked Division I AA football team in the nation in Georgia Southern. Now, the fans here in Corvallis expect a big Beaver win. Steve, will they get it?
In a word, yes. The Beavers should win. They are bigger. They are stronger. They better play better competition. They have more scholarships. But do you think Dennis Erickson is not concerned? You're wrong. He's scared about this game. Are the Beavers prepared?
Well, one guy that I know Georgia Southern's a little scared of is Kim Simonton, Oregon State's fine running back, Pac-10 Offensive Player of the Week.
And he should have been the last 2 weeks. This guy's having a phenomenal year. Leads the Pac-10, as you see, with 188 yards a game, second in the nation, scoring 15 a game. Mr. Do-Everything, I'd like to see him sitting on the bench by the fourth quarter with a big lead.
Well, Georgia Southern certainly has some players who can make things happen. The guy who starts it all is the quarterback, Greg Hill.
Well, Greg Hill is a young man that's from Sarasota, Florida, where Tim Alexander was from. He passed for 1,000, ran for 1,000 last year. That's scary in itself because he can do it all. He can do it both ways, and the Beavers can't load the box with 9 people to stop the wishbone.
Georgia Southern's head coach is Paul Johnson. In his third season, what a record, 26-4. Of course, his team played for the 1AA championship a year ago. And Dennis Erickson, in his first season as head coach here at Oregon State University in Corvallis, Erickson 2-0 this season, 115 wins, tied for 14th in Division I active coaches. The Oregon State Beavers won the coin toss and have elected to get the football. Chris Chambers, a senior, will do the kicking here. Lawrenceville, Georgia, 5'9", 177 pounds. And the Oregon State return guys, Robert Prescott and Antonio Battle. Prescott to the right of your screen, Battle to the left side. And we're just about ready to get underway. Second home game of the season for the Oregon State University Beavers, who won last week's game against Fresno State after winning the season opener at Nevada. Now here we go. Chris Chambers kicks it high, and it's going to be battled at about the 9 to the 20. And oh, what a nice play coming up to make the stop. It's number 97, Jamar Jones. He's one of the starting linebackers, and Jamar Jones on special teams comes up to make the stop.
Nice coverage there. Very nice coverage. Jonathan Smith, Beavers quarterback, having a heck of a year. Leads the Pac-10 in total offense as well as pass offense. Read the defense great against Fresno State. This is a defense that Jonathan Smith has to pick and choose what he's going to do. Is he going to run the football? Is he going to throw it? Take what he gives him.
51% completion ratio, 560 yards, 3 touchdowns, just the 1 interception. And we're ready for the first play from scrimmage here on a beautiful day in Corvallis. Smith, lots of time to throw, does throw, and this is complete. And it could be a big gainer. Montero Jones into across midfield. Jones to the 35, 34-yard line. Right away, the Beavers showing they have big play potential. Monjero Jones with the reception, 47-yard pickup on the first play from scrimmage.
Nice job by Jonathan Smith, standing in there waiting, and a great catch by Monjero Jones. Watch the poise right here. Now look at this. This is a tough pass, folks. Great catch, and that's what the Beaver coaches have been waiting for from Monjero Jones. We've seen it now out of all three of these big-name junior college receivers. This guy can make things happen.
Just his fifth catch as a Beaver, 4 receptions, 28 yards previous to that one. He more than doubles his output on the first catch. It gets down to the 38-yard line. That's where the Beavers have it first and 10. There's Ken Simonton. number 35, the guy we talked about in the open, over 100 yards in each of the first two games of the season. Jamar Jones making the stop as Simonton went up the middle.
Beavers have to get a fast start. That's the whole secret here. Look at the starters.
Keith DiDomenico back at center. He'd missed the first two games with an injury, replacing Chris Gibson, who started those two games. He's out with an injury. There's your backs and receivers. T.J. Hushmanzada, number 18. He'll see some action today. The ball will be thrown his way, the junior college transfer. Game just underway. Simonton, the pitch to him. He's got a first down inside the 20. Eugene Phillips, the right tackle, number 91, makes the stop. One of the seniors on the front line. There's Vonsilius Allen, who is the nose tackle. Coach Dennis Erickson says he may be one of the best we'll see all year. Dante Harrow, one of four linebackers. And the defensive backs, Earthwind Moreland and Kiwaki Thomas. These are some fine corners, Dennis Erickson says. They're about as good as we're going to see.
And great speed on the corners. That's not an issue. They can play in the back 10, those two guys.
First and 10 at the 19. Smith, naked in the backfield, five receivers. He's thrown, got a guy open in and out of the hands of Robert Prescott.
Well, you won't see that often. Robert Prescott has been absolutely glue. I think that's a situation where he was wide open, knew it was a touchdown. He thought about it. Got to have that catch. Got to have it. Great blocking their offensive line. And Robert makes a wonderful post-corner move. Just catch the ball. He was so far open, he forgot about catching it.
He was looking for his first touchdown catch of the year. I think he was a little surprised to be so open. Again, five receiver set. Monty Percoats wide to the right side. They might, oh, look out. Smith's in trouble, and down he goes. Number 21, LeVar Rainey, coming up to make the stop from his left corner position.
Well, you think of big plays. The Beavers should be up 7-0 right now, down kicking off. As you look at Rainey right there, the five receiver set puts huge pressure on the defense. They have to cover the slot man with a linebacker if they don't have a nickel in. That's one of the reasons Robert Prescott was so wide open, as you see the blitz come through there from Rainey.
Third down and 17. Beavers have to get to the 9 for a first down. Smith looking things over. All alone, looking, picking and choosing. Finds his receiver. He's got the first down inside the 10 to the 5. Monjaro Jones again. Smith to Jones.
Inside the 10. Close to the 8. It'll be
first and goal for the Beavers at the 5.
Take a look. He's coming from the outside, folks. No, he isn't. He's inside slot man in the trips. Just a nice pattern. Again, they're trying to cover Monjaro Jones with a linebacker. Jason Neese, he can't do it. He's their middle backer, folks.
In this situation, most of the season, we've seen it go to Simonton. There's the handoff. There's the hole. There's the touchdown.
Big play, and you call it absolutely on the numbers, Scott. When you got Ken Simonton and you got an offensive line that's playing like this Beaver offensive line has played for three games, you give him the football, let him score the points.
Ryan Seska, true freshman, comes on to do the point after. Roddy Tompkins to hold. The spot is good, the kick is up, and it is good, and the Beavers tack on the extra point. So less than 3 minutes into the football game, Ken Simonton and the Beavers march right down the field for the go-ahead touchdown.
Watch the block out of this guy. He just holds him off. Great block outside. Wow. That was, I believe, DiDomenico coming to the outside. Nice block by Robert Sykes. Jason White, offensive line, playing out of their heads for 3 weeks.
Aaron Cook and Mitch White on the right side. And, yes, Ken Simonton, the recipient, as he gets the touchdown. That is his sixth rushing touchdown of the season, and that makes 10 over the last four games.
Well, you know, this is a guy who's got 600 yards in the last three games, Scott. That's pretty tough. He's just played super football. As you look at Jonathan Smith on the sideline, you notice that's Dennis Erickson, folks. Dennis coaches the quarterbacks, and Michael Johnson helped him. It looks like they're talking to Jonathan. I'm not sure. I hope he isn't injured right there. They're bringing people in to discuss the offense, discuss what he's supposed to be doing.
And talking with Prescott maybe about the communication on that particular play in which the drop came.
Well, the communication was between his brain and his fingers, Scott.
On that drive, you got to give credit as well to Smith for the passing ability as he found Monjera Jones. 68 yards, two catches there. This is the last week, the SNS show. Smith and Simonton, 300 yards passing for Smith, and Simonton, 200 all-purpose yards, four touchdowns, Pac-10 Offensive Player of the Week.
And it's nice to know these guys are sophomores. They played a lot of football for Oregon State, and they're only sophomores. What a way to start with this Dennis Erickson system. Two more years of these guys after this year that we've barely begun.
So Oregon State off to a good start, and that's exactly the kind of thing that'll make Dennis Erickson breathe a little easier. As you said right at the outset, Steve, he's very nervous.
Absolutely.
About this football game. Again, we'll see the double slot. They'll run some option out of that, and it's going to be a situation where the Beavers are going to see something they don't see a lot of.
Well, the Beavers don't see it in the Pac-10 at all anymore, unless they used to play themselves. I guess that's the last time they really saw it. The coach came from Hawaii, where the Beavers played him in 89, beat the Beavers with this. He doesn't want to call it a wishbone, but that's what it is. It's a wishbone out of the double slot. The thing they do is they pass from it. That's what makes it tough.
Seska kicks off. Anthony Williams and Benny Cunningham are back. This is Williams at about the 3. To the 15, slowed down and hammered down before he gets back to the 20. Good work for Oregon State special teams.
Field position is huge in this game. This team has started over the 50 16 times and scored 15 times of them. As you look at this guy, Greg Hill, number 10, All-American returning quarterback. You see his last week's stats. Remember, he throws the football. So far this year, it's been the fullback, Peterson and Hill, running. Slots haven't touched the ball much.
It's the pitch around the outside. And close to the first down, that's Sherrard Freeman, one of the slot backs, and we may see a lot of pitching to the slots today.
Well, the secret of covering this defense we'll get into as it goes, as you look at the slot back there. There's an injured Beaver, Darnell Robinson, I believe.
While we have a player down on the field, we'll look at the offensive line here. Mark Williams, the guy they call Bus. He is the right guard, and he is a very good one, an NFL prospect. One of two guys on that front line that are three-year letter winners. The other three guys are first-year starters. Backs and receivers. Adrian Peterson, the fullback you talk about. This is a guy with 7 rushing touchdowns, 8 touchdowns overall in the first two games. Number 3, Adrian Peterson, is a guy that the Beavers will be keying on today.
Absolutely. He is a good football player, only 207 pounds, but he's a load. He's a great football player. You watch Darnell go off with looks like a shoulder injury of sorts. Freeman had not carried the ball this season, Scott. He's a blocker normally.
And you see Robinson not happy about it, as he apparently is hurt. Robinson with an interception for a touchdown last week. Remember, he came to Oregon State as an option quarterback. When he got the touchdown, I had a chance to talk with him this past week, and he said, hey, I know what it's like to score. I used to do it all the time when I was playing offense.
Well, he's earned this starting job. He has earned it, as you watch Peterson scuffle right there. Darnell Robinson doesn't like to give up that starting job, and he won't give it up real easy.
Micah Moore coming in, replacing him, and there is DeLawrence Grant, number 1. You're looking in the face there of Ladarius Jackson. Those two guys are the bookends. They are junior college guys. They were teammates together, and they are good ones. There's your middle linebacker, Jonathan Jackson, number 2 in the Pac-10 in tackles a year ago. He is a good one. And Terrence Carroll, the junior, who has one of the Beaver interceptions this year, he is a guy who headlines the secondary for Oregon State. First down and 10, as they just gave him enough forward progress. And there the Beavers cover Micah Moore on top of them right there, and Grant there too. And now some laundering comes down on the field very late.
Well, it's a late flag. Beavers had it handled real well. Hopefully this is something against the offense, because it did drop in way late. Could have been a late hold, a late shot at somebody downfield.
Micah Moore, number 27, you were looking at moments ago.
Looks like they're walking the Beavers back.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense, 15 yards, first down.
Chuck McFerrin, our referee today. Art Hines, the umpire. Dan Antoinette, the head linesman. Blake Lozo, the line judge. Jerry Gastellum, the field judge. Craig Rolstad is the side judge. And Mike Angelis is the back judge today, as Dennis Erickson paces the sidelines. That's something he doesn't want to see today, too.
No, the Beavers have been very, very little penalized this year. That's a sign of a disciplined team. That gives a first down instead of a third and long.
At the 45, Georgia Southern, nice pitch to the fullback. Peterson gets into Oregon State territory before he's brought down by James Allen. And again, you mentioned it a moment ago, they've been into an opponent's territory 16 times this year. They have scored 15 touchdowns. That's a 94% completion rate. And to give you an idea of how good they are, last year they were 73% anytime they got into opponent territory.
Wow, that's amazing. Well, you look at this, it's just a little delayed option. Look at the lineman out there running. Nice play by James Allen, forcing the pitch. Good block outside by, that's Freeman, number 19, the back that blocks so well.
And now a timeout is being called for momentarily at least.
Sean Ball is injured. He's the one that called the timeout. Middle defensive lineman. Scott, the thing that you think about with a wishbone is, number one, they split the defense out. We'll get a look at these splits very soon that show the linemen about a half a yard farther out than they always do. It's just to create holes, create a bigger hole for the fullback up the middle. The secret of playing defense against the wishbone is first alignment, that's getting in the right place with these big splits, and second assignment. You want to put at least one and a half man, usually two man, on everybody that hurts you, starting with the fullback, then the quarterback.
Eric Manning has checked in for Ball, and here is a pitch outside, and he's brought down. Benny Cunningham, another one of the slots. That's just his third carry of the year. Terrence Carroll coming up from the safety position to stop him.
Well, obviously, from looking at the stats, the quarterback and fullback have carried the ball. Nobody's made him pitch. The Beavers are going to make him pitch. Get it out of Hill and Peterson's hands. They're the guys you don't want with the football.
Greg Hill, the quarterback, fifth-year senior out of Riverview High School, the same high school that produced Tim Alexander. In fact, Hill was the guy that replaced him as the quarterback when Alexander moved on to Oregon State, and there is great effort by Oregon State, and I don't believe he got it. Peterson stopped up at the line of scrimmage.
That was a big, big play on defense right there. Super, Jonathan Jackson. Fifth in the Pac-10 now, and as good a linebacker in the middle as I think there is in the Pac-10 this year. Second last year and makes a ton of tackles. Smart. Now we're going to see here. This is a big situation for a team like this. They go for the first down. They get it. It gives them momentum. I got to believe they're going to run the option here. I think this is foolish, Scott. I think they should be kicking the ball. If they get it, great. If they miss it, big trouble.
They're 1-for-1 on fourth down conversions this year. Hill says, wow, it's kind of noisy. I got to go over and hand deliver the audible here. Fourth down. First down. Hill! Big gainer. Hill may score. Keith Hayward Johnson chases him out of bounds. First down and then some for Greg Hill, and a little bit of Tim Alexander look-alike right there.
Well, no question. He makes a great move here. The Beavers do a good job with the first pitch. They're expecting the fullback to get this. Take a look right here. He'll fake as the fullback blasts through, take about a step down, but not ever get outside. Cut inside, gets good blocking. Look at this. They had three linemen on the right side. Just an excellent job, and boy, he did look like Tim Alexander. Didn't we have a number 10 here a couple years ago?
Yeah, just last year, if you'll recall. First and goal at the 7-yard line, and Georgia Southern, the nation's number one ranked 1AA team, is knocking on the door trying to tie it. Up the middle. Touchdown, I believe. Yes, sir. Adrian Peterson. His eighth rushing touchdown of the season, and the crowd's kind of going, wow, what is this?
Well, you know, this is one bad play by the Beavers and one silly penalty that got him in trouble. As you take a look here, just hands it off to the good fullback, and he does hit. Calvin Carlisle's got to make that tackle. Surprised Darnell over there a little bit. He wasn't ready to hit it after Calvin hit it. Big play on 4th and 1. Give the coach credit. I believe you kicked the football right then, get the Beavers down inside, but he took the chance, made it pay off, touchdown. Now we got a football game.
Good team. Adrian Peterson and the Eagles have tied it here in Corvallis. .902 left first quarter, tie game, Steve.
Well, just an excellent job right in here. These guys cave it in to the inside. Fullback comes down, bounces through, and then just uses a great effort to get to the outside and score. Excellent job right there, and again, free safety's got to make that hit. He just wasn't expecting him to come loose. The big pile, he didn't think anybody was coming through. You got to stay ready. Don't want to give Georgia Southern a reason to believe they're in the football game.
81-yard drive, eight plays. Adrian Peterson takes it over. His eighth touchdown of the season on the ground, his ninth touchdown of the season. He's a guy who has rushed for 100 yards or more in 17 consecutive games. Talking to the folks from Georgia Southern, a lot of the riders and so forth, they think that streak could end here today, but it didn't look like it. This is a pretty good team. Best of 1AA, you bet. Ranking number one in scoring at 65.5 points per. They rush for 370 yards per game. Prescott and Battle again back to receive for Oregon State.
You got to do your job. You got to do your assignment against the wishbone. No question about it. Willie Robinson, Oregon State's defensive coordinator, seen this before, I can tell you that. And he knows you got to teach these kids to keep your assignment, keep your position, and make plays.
Chambers kicks it off. And again, it's heading in the direction of Antonio Battle. His first return of the year early in the game was a pretty good one. This one gets out to about the 24, 25-yard line before he is chased out of bounds by Kewaukee Thomas.
Well, you look at those first two drives. Oregon State went 80 yards in seven plays, consumed only 246. Came right back with Georgia Southern. 81 yards, eight plays. 3 minutes and 2 seconds, so a lot of scoring here real quick. Again, the Beavers had it going their way on defense. One mistake with a penalty, a late hit, I think, or at least just chicken fighting out there, and then certainly one big play.
Antonio Battle, the return man on the kickoff there, is a walk-on this year, and Jonathan Smith, a former walk-on, is the team's starting quarterback. A quick hitter to Imani Percoats, and right away the corner Kewaukee Thomas is there to stop him. Here's Percoats, who had a big game, a coming out party last week against Fresno State. Five receptions, 126 yards and a couple of TD catches. And the amazing thing, Steve, none of us knew it at the time, he was playing with a heavy heart as his girlfriend of the last couple of years had passed away in an automobile accident. Her funeral was last Saturday. He was playing in her memory. And the family had said, please, I know she'd want you to play. Go ahead and do it and have a great game, and he did.
Well, he had a great game, and he's a real talent. The official almost blew that net too quick, to tell you the truth.
This is T.J. Hushmanzada for the first down to the 40. Hushmanzada, junior college transfer out of Cerritos College, picking up with his seventh reception of the season.
Well, this is a little swing screen. He comes out of the slot position, I believe, right here. Comes out of the slot. Unloads, it's a lateral right there. People blocking down field. Mongero Jones gets a good block. Nice block right there by, that was Roddy, I'm not sure. Excellent play by the Beavers, and obviously they believe the five receiver set works, that they can't, that that's an advantage to them because Ken Simonton wasn't in the field.
Now Simonton is in and trips to the right side. The handoff to Simonton, big hole, Simonton! First down into Georgia Southern territory to the 42-yard line. Ken Simonton.
Great hole, just an excellent job by offensive left side of the line again, and downfield, watch the blocking downfield. It is sensational towards the end of the run. Play's gonna come right between these two guys, should get a standoff here and a block there. Kenny's just gonna take it straight ahead. Oops, I missed it a hole, folks, but there it is, there he comes inside. That's just great vision. He finds the hole, finds where the block was, knew where I was gonna draw it and got there.
18-yard pickup before Rainey stopped him, and now a little play action. Smith to throw. Oh, nearly picked off. In and out of the hands of Kewaukee Thomas, who almost picked it off. That pass intended for Prescott, a number two. We talked about the corners earlier. These guys are both very fast. Thomas is a speed burner. I'll tell you what, he can run like the wildfire, and you got Earth, Wind, Moreland on the other side. You got Earth, Wind, and Fire there at the corners.
Oh, that's
it's
good.
Music to the very ears of the good. Eagle fans.
Well, the Beavers thought they were going to be able to play pass off of Ken Simonton. They tried it right there, but for some reason, you got a zone out of that team. They were all sitting there waiting.
Second and 10 to Simonton. No, no hole there this time. Georgia Southern's front stacks it up. Eugene Phillips, Fonsellius Allen, Robert LeBlanc. They are the starters. Again, a 3-4 alignment here, a three-man front.
Well, it's a little different than the Beavers see most of the time in the Pac-10. The reason you play a 3-4 more than anything else is you just don't have enough big linemen in the middle. You got better athletes outside. It's more versatile. You can bring people from all over and get your 4 or 5-man rush from anywhere. That helps. But in this case, it's really a size issue. They got a whole bunch of linebackers at 200 to 215 pounds.
Five receivers again. Trips to the right side. And nobody over here. Looks like the Beavers have an advantage on the right side, do they not? Let's see, Smith throws. Darrell Jones drops it. He was about a yard shy of the first down, but he would have had it easily, but a drop, and we've seen the Beavers have trouble holding on to the ball today. Now, concentration could be an issue because, and I know Coach was worried about that.
Well, you know, you do worry, and both drops have been with wide open pass patterns. The kids don't catch it in their hands or just don't look at the ball. They think, I got to catch it, and they start thinking, you know, don't think, it spoils the team. Do what you've been practicing.
Mike Fessler on to punt. Anthony Williams is back, standing at his 10-yard line. That's going to be a pretty decent punt. Takes a big Georgia Southern hop. It'll go out inside the 20, though not all bad for Mike Fessler. Rather that than booming it into the end zone for the touchback. 6:41 left, still tied at 7. First down and 10, Georgia Southern with the football for the second time. And the Beavers stack it up in the middle pretty good. Beaver defense going to have to rise to the occasion here. Jonathan Jackson, the middle linebacker, coming in to stop it up along with Ball. Aaron Wells, number 49.
John Ball in on the stop.
Well, the way the Beavers play this is Jonathan Jackson has the fullback. Forget the quarterback, forget the scrape. He's got the fullback, he's hitting him. He needs another half-man help from one of those two in the middle, those two defensive linemen. You're going to get a scrape out of the safety and the linebackers. There's an offensive offsides, I believe. But you're going to get a scrape to the outside quarterback from the outside linebackers and ends. They got to play the quarterback and hit him. And the pitch man, that's just Oregon State speed. It's got to come from safeties and linebackers reacting and cornerbacks.
Dead ball, false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty.
Thank you, Chuck McFerrin. Chuck, like all of us, might want to know that tonight at 7 from Las Vegas, it's the Sunday Night Fights. Former WBC champ Wayne McCullough goes toe-to-toe with Len Martinez in a 10-round super bantamweight bout. Tonight at 7 right here on Fox Sports Net Northwest. We're here at Research Stadium in Corvallis. Scott Lynn and Steve Priest with you. Georgia Southern with the football. It's the option. And the Beavers cover it pretty well. James Allen, a linebacker with great speed, one of the big, big deterrents against the option.
Well, no question. Speed, speed, speed. The thing the Beavers will do with the pitch is they'll get there with their athletic ability and speed. Look at that. It's a nice misdirection, trying to catch the flow there with the middle linebacker and some people, but just great speed. Gets out there and play. Now, we haven't seen a pass, and in the open we talked about this guy's balanced offense as you look at Benny Cunningham right there. I expect to see a pass. What do you do in a wishbone on third down? You run some kind of an option into the outside and drop back and throw. We'll see what their strategy is.
Third and 12, got to get to the 29 for the first. First pass coming up here. Coming back the other way, and that is Dedrick Parham. And he's got the first down and then some, and he's out of bounds finally. But another big play. Calvin Carlisle pushes him out of bounds. But Dedrick Parham, who had a team-high 6 receptions coming in, with a big play here.
Well, I couldn't tell about the defense right here. I believe it was man-to-man. Looks man-to-man. That means somebody's just got to stay on their receiver. Now the Beavers look like we're in a zone. Take a look at the block here by 71. Couldn't quite see it. Good job right there.
He does a nice job walking that tightrope, doesn't he?
He sure does, and the Beavers don't want to let these guys get hope up. Again, this is a tough football team.
I think it's too late, Steve. They have the hope right now. Quarterback still with it. Hill keeps it, picks up about 5 yards
Greg
on the
Hill
play
on the keeper.
To about the 47-yard line. Greg Hill, number 10.
Boy, does he look like Tim Alexander,
doesn't he? Same kind of
moves.
Yep.
Great job faking the football as you look at Coach right there.
Paul Johnson. First 2 years he has been recognized by some services as National Coach of the Year in Division I AA. Program with great tradition. 4 national championships after resurrecting the program 19 years ago. That's not going to be a first down there. The Beavers stack them up. Peterson has nowhere to go.
You know, Scott, we talk about the big play with this team. Talk about that. They've been averaging over 6 big plays a game this year and last year. You remember us talking about that years ago when Oregon State ran
big
the
play.
Wishbone. You got to have the big play to win with the wishbone. And this team has gotten 3 big plays so far. 3 big plays. 2 of them have kept drives going.
3rd down and 4, ball at the 48 of Georgia Southern. Got to get to the 48 of Oregon State for a first. Hill with Peterson behind him, now looking to throw, chased out of the pocket, and he is going to be short of the first down by about a yard. Darnell Robinson comes back in to make the play. Robinson, good to see that his shoulder injury on the early play there is not too serious. He's back in the game.
Looks like he's there, and folks, we're back in exactly the same situation as the first drive. It's going to be 4th and a yard, exactly what they had in the last time. So look at this great run. Just a great athlete. Good job of defense and following up, but here's the same situation as the big play last time. Let's see if he runs the same play. Don't you do that? If it works once, you come back with it. Let's see what happens.
4th down and 1. Just over 3 minutes left in the first. Greg Hill calls timeout.
Nice try there. That was good strategy. Quarterback barked. They sent the guy in motion. It looked like motion, but the slot back was just going back to a different position. They tried. Now let's see if they come out and try to kick the football or if they're going to run it again. They tried to sneak one in for a first down with a penalty. It didn't work as you look at young Mr. Hill.
The Georgia Southern Eagles, 1AA football team, ranked number 1 in the nation, 2-0 on the year. You know, golf's Ryder Cup captain Ben Crenshaw is going to go one-on-one with Chris Myers on tonight's Going Deep. Crenshaw has lashed out at certain Ryder Cup members who want to be paid for their participation. He has 19 PGA victories. He's worn the green jacket twice, winning the Masters in 84 and 95. It's Going Deep tonight at 9 on Fox Sports Net Northwest. Georgia Southern, as I say, 2-0, beat Fayetteville State 76-0, a school record 76 points, scoring 3 touchdowns in each of the first 3 quarters, and then beat Wofford last week 55-14. They've outscored their opponents 131-14 coming into this football game, and they're giving the Beavers all they can handle here in the first quarter. Tied at 7, 4th down and 1. Option, Hill pitches, it's on the turf! Great hop! And I think they get the first. Sherrard Freeman.
Called it an incomplete pass.
Oh, my goodness.
What a break for the Beavers.
That's a lateral, Steve. Was it not? I mean, I'll have to look at it again, perhaps. But to me, that was a lateral.
Well, I know it was close. I wouldn't have picked it up without the call, that's for sure. But now you look at it, you think, wow, he started to cut up field and then took a step back. Well, we'll never know unless we have a replay. We'll see here. Take a look here. Here's where the quarterback is. He's up.
Boy, it's very close.
I tell you, I would call that a lateral myself, Scott. I think the quarterback stepped up. Maybe the official looked because it was coming out of his right hand.
Oh, Paul Johnson doesn't like it, does he?
He sure doesn't. Now let's see if, this is a team that has to win a football game, so you wonder if they could run it from here. What the heck is going on?
Simonton, the ball carrier. And he is stopped by 97 Jamar Jones, the outside linebacker, sophomore out of Douglasville, Georgia. You know, you look at this team defensively, Georgia Southern, not just defensively, but on their roster, 66 of the 90 kids on the roster are from the state of Georgia, 12 are from Florida, 4 from South Carolina. You know, all of those players were very concerned with Hurricane Floyd this past week.
I'll bet. I bet they were real happy to. I don't believe there was any problem with families, and they were able to get out of town and stay in their own dorm until they did, and it was safe, so that's great. As the Beavers are in 5 receivers again, and it's just wide open at the top. They got the right play called. Wow.
Fumble fingers has been the only thing to stop them when they've gone
Absolutely.
To the 5 receivers. All kinds of time, and it is complete. No fumble on this one. Monjaro Jones. He may stay in bounds. He may score, and he does. Touchdown, Oregon State.
Huge play. Huge effort by a guy. And watch the blocking in the line, and then watch the blocking downfield. Wow. What is this, a coming out party every week for a transfer?
Monjaro Jones with his first touchdown reception as an Oregon State Beaver. 6-foot junior out of West Los Angeles College. You know, we talk about the guys who played at El Camino Junior College, Grant and Jackson. This guy also was at that school for a year. He was teammates with those guys.
Well, I remember that's one of the reasons he came here, is because of those guys, the fact they were here. They talked about going somewhere together.
51-yard touchdown pass to Monjaro Jones gives Oregon State the 14-7 lead. Stick around. Oregon State takes a 14-7 lead on the 51-yard pass. Smith to Jones.
Well, look at the protection. This is just a great job. Nice throw and a good catch. I didn't realize that that ball was a little bit behind. And again, linebacker trying to take the inside. Now watch him tightrope down the sideline. Look at the blocks there. Great job. That was TJ and Percoats doing it. Oh, my gosh.
And as we come back to the action, we have a return for a touchdown.
We missed one there, folks, a little bit. Great play, obviously.
That is Benny Cunningham. We'll see it in a moment. Benny Cunningham, return for touchdown, and you wanted fireworks today? You got him.
Well, I'm sure that Dennis Erickson is going to have some say with some people. This Beaver coverage team has been great all year, and this is a situation where somebody's just letting down a little bit, if you will.
Chris Chambers will come on to try the point after that will tie it. 89-yard officially on the return by Cunningham. We'll see it in just a moment, but we will first show you the point after as they try to tie the score at 14. Still in the first quarter, the Georgia Southern Eagles providing some excitement here in Corvallis. That kick is up. It is good. We're tied at 14. And now let's take a look at Benny Cunningham.
Well, it was a very short kick. Very short kick. They got him pinned right where they want to. You couldn't be better off by pinning him against the sideline. That's what you need to do. But a missed tackle early. People got out of their lanes early. There was a hole there created by people jamming up instead of staying in their lanes and breaking down. Major mistake by one or two guys. All you need is a one-man mistake on a kickoff.
Benny Cunningham with a return. It's his first touchdown of the year in any capacity. He's one of the starting slot backs, and man, he just went right there, didn't he? Whoa, my goodness.
And you have to remember the mentality here. That is keeping Georgia Southern excited. And the Beavers have, gone down and scored twice, workmanlike, done a good job, and all of a sudden they're in a football game.
Well, it's kind of a little beside the point at this point, but I was going to mention great block on the Oregon State touchdown by Robert Prescott, number 82. He had made a great play. Perhaps you saw it on the replay. But before I could even get that out, the game's tied again. My, oh, my. Georgia Southern, prolific scoring team, but they're doing it with special teams.
They are,
too.
They are. They've had, that's three big plays so far in this football game of over 20 yards for them already. Let's see if Oregon State can return the favor. You look for anything. You can see onsides, you name it.
You could. Battle, by the way, who's returned the first two, has had 16 returns of kickoffs for touchdowns in high school. So he has the ability. He knows how to take him back. This one, though, is going to go to Prescott. First time he'll return one today at the 10. 20, 25, and rolls over to almost the 30.
Big play there. Robert Prescott's had a remarkable season so far. I saw the pass last week when the Beavers had a 3rd and 12 just after the half. Had to have a first down, 3rd and 12, 8-yard line. Jonathan Belt stuck it in his ear. It was behind him. He made a great catch for a first down. Beavers went on and won the football game from that one catch.
Jonathan Smith, 5 of 8 today, and there's the total yardage. Oregon State, 164 yards. Georgia Southern, 103. We're still in the first quarter, and that doesn't... we're talking the special teams here, the big return as well. And here's the handoff. Simonson plastered.
And Simonson, the carrier.
Coming up to get him is Jason Neese, one of the inside linebackers. Here's number 31, Neese, who just made the stop.
Well, Neese is the guy who's had the coverage on the inside man in the trips formation. Monjaro Jones twice, actually had it a third time, or another time for a touchdown that Robert Prescott dropped. So he's the guy who's got a lot of pressure on him. When five receivers come in, he's got to go out and play somebody that's a whole lot better catching balls than he is.
Smith, 5 of 8, 135 yards and a touchdown. And looking to throw again, and that pass is incomplete. It comes bouncing into the hands of the defensive back, Arky Thompson. Incomplete pass. Smith now 5 of 9. Smith and Jones have been the combination today. Jones with three catches, 119 yards, and the touchdown, and another one that was dropped.
Well, Arkie Thompson right there that's playing and starting at free safety today. He's in there to give pass coverage. He is not the normal starter. The two safeties are normally big hitters. They move the normal free safety to strong. Arkie, who was a player and starter last year, is back at it.
Oregon State calling a timeout there as they came out of the huddle. You had the receivers not knowing where to go on that play. You could tell there was general confusion, and Jonathan Smith says, I got to go talk this over with coach. This is a big, big football game for Jonathan Smith and Dennis Erickson. The Beavers have been talking about you got to be 3-0 heading into your Pac-10 season, and the only team that is in the way of that is Georgia Southern. Forget about them being 1AA. Forget about them being smaller. The Beavers are in a position where they just simply have to win today. Tomorrow night at 7 on Fox Sports Net Northwest Tonight, highlights of today's Seahawks-Bears game. Catch up with Washington Husky head football coach Rick Neuheisel and take a walk down Press Row with Northwest media members, plus the Northwest sporting news of the day. That's tomorrow night at 7 on Fox Sports Net Northwest. And the longer that this game goes, the more the Beavers seem to be playing with a little tentative style, and certainly Georgia Southern feeling better and better about themselves.
Well, I think I agree with the second part. I think Georgia Southern does feel better about themselves. I think that one timeout's the only tentative we've seen. We've seen a couple of drop passes. Those aren't tentative mistakes. They're guys making silly mistakes. I think Dennis would be very worried about that. But I think the Beavers are going to stay in this game. They just need to get it over with. They need to start playing the kind of football they should on defense and on special teams.
Erickson 2-0, of course, went at Miami of Florida playing against Georgia Southern. Johnson is actually 1-0 against Oregon State as he was Hawaii's offensive coordinator. And now Smith goes down. And there again, number 97 making the stop and a flag on the play. Jamar Jones, the linebacker, came up to stop it, but we have a flag down.
Well, this is a wide open guy. Nobody blocks him. Oregon State has a missed cover right there because he comes from the outside linebacker position. Just nobody touches him at all. Face mask will buy the Beavers out of this one, folks.
Smith saying, wow.
Face mask on the defense. 15 yards.
15 yarder, so obviously he kept his hand there. Big play for Oregon State because that was a pretty good shot. Look at this guy. Oops, he moved already. He's going to come absolutely clean. The linemen have to bounce out there or else, oh, yeah, heaven's sakes. That was dangerous. Should have been 15, that's for sure. What has to happen there is you're either in a zone area, slide area, where the tackle slides out and the guard comes out to the next guy in. That didn't happen in that case. It looked to me like the right guard was supposed to be coming to the outside as the toss comes this way.
Simonton trying to get around the corner, picks up about 5 or 6. Coming up to make the stop was Dante Harrow.
Make a little try at explaining that again. Offensive linemen either play in zones and bounce out and take people in front of them, kind of count off an area, in which case the tackle gets to that guy. If they're playing pure man, the tackle takes the guy to the outside shoulder, and if there's somebody out beyond that, then the guard has to come back from the inside and pick him up. That's what I believe happened there. Aaron Cook, the right guard, or else the center, who was ever uncovered, had to get back and make that play.
We have come to the end of the first quarter. Jonathan Smith and the Beavers will talk things over while they change positions on the field. 14-14 here in Corvallis. Don't go away. Welcome back to Research Stadium in Corvallis, Oregon. Georgia Southern and Oregon State tied at 14 as we head to the second quarter. Scott Lynn along with Steve Priest. It's a beautiful day, but a lot of people wearing the orange and black here today just a little bit nervous as the nation's number one ranked Division I AA team has come in and played Oregon State even thus far. Look at the time of possession. It's almost even, too.
Well, you look at the total yards, Oregon State pretty well dominating that, but again, time of possession has been close, and the game's 14-14.
Second and 3, and Simonton up the middle has the first down across the 40 to the 39-yard line. Simonton stopped by Robert LeBlanc, a left tackle. Simonton, who got his 6th rushing touchdown of the year earlier today. He's trying for his 7th career 100-yard game and trying for his 4th in a row, which would tie the OSU record.
Pete Pfeiffer, a great fullback, happened to play with him myself as a sophomore. He was 2 years ahead of me, just a great fullback. had a number of 100-yard games.
In fact, he had two streaks of four. Smith throwing. Intended for Hushmanzada, overthrew him.
That's a big mismatch right there, folks. Haddon, who's the normal free safety, moved over to Strong. He can't cover TJ. TJ had come from his outside shoulder and beat him inside. Just didn't quite have, well, you see TJ limping a little bit. Looks like he's got a ham or something. But he, Jonathan didn't have the time and actually had somebody on the outside of him, so he couldn't throw it where he needed to throw that.
For Coates and Jones to the right side. Prescott and Tompkins, Roddy Tompkins to the left side. Simon to the running back. Smith behind center. 14-14, second down play. Simonton, the hole plugged up in a hurry. Simonton still picks up three, close to the 35. Make it the 36-yard line. Freddie Pesqueda. Pesqueda comes up to make the stop. Number 44, this kid's a true freshman out of Acworth, Georgia. He started last week. He had a very impressive fall. They were going to redshirt him. They said, hey, we can't. This kid's pretty good. Earned a job and getting big minutes. It's not spelled the same way it's pronounced. It's Pesqueda. So I wrote it phonetically on my chart, just to let you know, because I couldn't do it the way it's spelled. Third down and seven. Smith to throw. Has time, got a receiver. Perkins, first down. Finally dropped down by Arkie Thompson.
I tell you, Earthwind Moreland has him absolutely covered. This is just a big body. Jonathan puts the ball right where he has to put it, and Armani just makes it an easy catch. Look at this guy. Wow. This is a great play. This makes a difficult play look easy. Wow. Nice job.
For Coates, a senior, junior college transfer, but he, again, only has 1 year of eligibility, as we mentioned a week ago.
And he's just really learning how to play the position. Too bad he doesn't have another year.
He told me this week, he said, I don't think of myself as a wide receiver. I'm an athlete. Mobley is in the game now. He takes the handoff. Mobley, his first carry of the day, Eric Mobley, third-year sophomore out of Lancaster, California. Dante Harrow makes the stop. Georgia Southern.
To him. I can't believe that. He was stopped and down and whistles blown and everything else.
Yeah. Beavers will continue to have the football.
But that's why you want to get Eric Mobley in the game. He has simply got to get used to the hits and get used to the fact that when you're halfway down, you think you're down, everybody's grabbing for the football. He hadn't played for a couple of years. He was hurt and redshirted. You know, he's got to get used to what happens in the game.
Saw his first action last week against Fresno State, carried four times for 11 yards. There's Percoats to the left side. He's all alone on this side. Simonton back in at running back. He has it. Big hole, Simonton! Did they give it to him? Not yet. No signal yet. No, they do not give him the touchdown. He stopped just short of it. The fans boo, but it's very, very close.
Well, this absolutely great blocking on the right side of the offensive line again. Oregon State brings in a tight end right now. Double. Look at this. Great hole right there. Excellent speed and quickness. Moves through and just a big surge.
And nice, a good call.
Nice call. Yeah. Nice call by the official. Beavers now will put in either two or three tight ends. Let's see. Two tight ends in.
Simonton with one touchdown on the day will likely get it here. Does. Pulls his way over for the touchdown. The Beavers take the lead. Barely got in, but got in nonetheless.
Well, you won't see ever anybody in that backfield with Kenny Simonton unless you're inside the three. Sometimes you'll see a third tight end as a blocker.
Second touchdown of the day for number 35. You go back to the Civil War game a year ago, that's 11 touchdowns for him. A scoring machine. Ryan Cheska in to try the point after.
Cheska better keep making these extra points.
And he did on that one. Early in the second quarter, Ken Simonton and the Beavers get back on front. But there's still a long, long way to go. I'll bet there'll be more points on the board before we're done. The rally squad from Oregon State University, a little bit happier now than it was a little while ago as Oregon State takes the lead.
Well, watch the surge. You see, nice job there by the actual defensive line. They stood Oregon State up pretty well. You got to keep your pads low when you're an offensive or a defensive lineman. In fact, let's talk about that, Scott. We're gonna look on the other side as you see Kenny Simonton get some cool towels. It is hot on that field today. That really generates it so far.
Simonton basically getting the same kind of yardage per play as the option attack of Georgia Southern.
Well, and you remember that they had a big play running the football, so that's really a stat.
Anthony Williams, kickoff. There you go. Still hanging around, got up to the 30. And a late flag. Late flag, and it could be against Oregon State, don't you think?
Oh, it is. Isaac White, number 40, knocks somebody on the ground and just pushes them over, makes a critical mistake, 15 yards right here, just trying to be aggressive, and it just can't happen. You got to keep your head. Isaac's having a heck of a fall and a heck of a season, but that's just uncalled for. That's the thing Dennis Erickson is very interested in stopping in a game like this.
And, Steve, in the first two games, the Beavers had just 9 penalties total, 51 yards, and here we're seeing some big ones and very costly ones.
Well, 2 personal fouls have really hurt the Beavers so far. This is another 15 yards, and wow.
There are 2 dead ball fouls on the play. Dead ball personal foul against the kicking team for 15 yards. A second dead ball personal foul against the kicking team for another 15 yards.
That's ridiculous.
Well, that's 30. You do the math, that's a lot, huh?
Well, that's ridiculous. And you can see Dennis Erickson over there. He's mad about something. I don't know what he's concerned about. He obviously couldn't see the Isaac White, but I didn't see the other. And to rip off 30 yards, wow, that's incredible. Go back to that statistic, Scott, too, that inside the 50, they've scored 15 out of 16 times.
There's Derek Williams, who was shaken up on the play there a little while ago. It looks like he's going to be able to shake it off, I would suspect. But there, it puts him right down at the 40 of Oregon State.
Well, you know what happens in a game like this? Georgia Southern is in here. They're real aggressive. Their offensive line chop blocks all the time, so it gets the defensive people a little bit ticked off, and all of a sudden you got them thinking about something other than their assignment.
First and 10 at the 40. Fullback has it. Peterson's going to score unless somebody can catch him. And he gets the touchdown, Adrian Peterson. And right now, another chance to tie for Georgia Southern.
Well, this Dennis Erickson has got to be beside himself with those kind of penalties and this kind of play. You know, you simply got to hit it with your middle linebacker. Now here you're always in a protection situation. You see Coach Erickson right there as they get kind of set for this trick extra point. Beavers have to defend it in case it's a two-pointer.
You had the center, the snapper, the holder, and the kicker ready to go. There it's down and it is up. And it is good, and that's a big point after for Chambers because it means, once again, we're tied here in Corvallis. Still early second quarter, and look how pumped Adrian Peterson is. He and his Eagles are tied with the Beavers out of the Pac-10. .11:55 left here in the first half. Georgia Southern is tied with Oregon State.
Well, you see, this is the guy who's going to come right through here. The Beavers, this guy's got to hit it and take it, but the play has to be made by the middle linebacker. He has to do it. Now, take a look. There it is. Nice block on that. Boy, they blocked Jonathan Jackson incredibly. If that happens, somebody's got to react and make the play, and it's going to have to be the free safety from right there.
Well, Adrian Peterson was number 3 in the voting for the Peyton Award last year, which is the 1AA version of the Heisman Trophy. And right there, a 40-yard run. Look at this, 57 yards on the day, 40 of it right there.
Well, the Beavers had done a great job of him before that. He was 6 for 17 yards until then. But you got to play the whole game, and the Beavers have given up 2 no-think touchdowns with penalties and just one-man mistakes.
Battle and Prescott are back. Prescott into the end zone, and he's going to have to say, let's take it out to the 20. So whereas Georgia Southern returned 189 yards for a touchdown, the Beavers, going the same direction, are going to have to take it out to the 20 and start first and 10. Georgia Southern, 51-33 on the road since 1985. Much of this, of course, against 1AA opponents. They like to play one Division I team every year, if possible, but they actually have trouble scheduling games down in the Southeast. The SEC teams certainly don't want to play them, and maybe for good reason. And then you look at what they've done against Division I teams. They've played some teams tough, but they're 0-11 in their history.
Well, they are tough to play. You don't want to play against a wishbone because you get people hurt.
Terrence Bryant in for the first time this year at quarterback, and he's going to run. Terrence Bryant in his first action since, what, game 8 a year ago. He had a two-game suspension that he had to serve, a minor violation, but he missed the first two games of this season. And Coach Erickson said, we're going to try to get him in the football game and get him used to playing because we need two quarterbacks.
Well, no question. And he's not in there because Jonathan did anything wrong. Contrary to that, he's in there because he's earned the opportunity. He was a starter last year. He played well in spring ball. He gives you a little bit better dimension when they have five receivers because he can run the draw a little more effectively than Jonathan Smith, who you look at right there.
And Jonathan, in fact, that's wonderful. He had no problems with the coach saying, hey, we're going to play two quarterbacks this week.
Well, I think it's great because you're taking a chance getting somebody hurt when you're sitting in there every play. Give Jonathan a little bit of time. It a lot of times helps a quarterback to sit there and watch it for a second.
False start against Oregon State. That's going to bring the Beavers back five.
And that's a factor of not being used to Terrence's cadence. Offensive lineman used to Jonathan's cadence. It's always just a little bit different. That costs the Beavers 5 yards. Beavers have to win first down. It's first and 15 now. They have to win first down.
Bryant last year set a Pac-10 record, an OSU record, with 170 consecutive passes without an interception. He's going to throw here. Got a guy out there. Prescott, if he can stay in bounds, he's gone. He stayed in. And now he's forced down, hammered down. And no flag. I thought it might have been a personal foul of sorts.
Boy.
As Kiwaki Thomas fisted him down. But
yeah.
Prescott, I thought he was going to be gone if he could stay in. But there you saw the great speed by the corner, Thomas.
Well, you know, it's a great job by Robert Prescott. First of all, I didn't think he stayed in. I thought he stepped out on the sideline. So the Beavers, whether they did or not, we don't know. But Terrence stands in there. Look at this catch. This is a great catch by a guy who dropped one a few minutes earlier. Now let's see if he really stays in bounds. I think he was on the line once or more right there.
They were right there to look at it, though.
Kiwaki tries to put it to, oh yeah, he should have been flagged right there. There is no doubt in my mind.
Simonton busts up to about the 11. Arky Thompson stops him about a half a yard shy of a first down. He's second down and a short one.
You can't tomahawk somebody in football. And that guy's bringing back a couple of tomahawks over the top. And that should have been called. The official missed it. I don't know what he was looking at.
At the sidelines.
Probably so. There are five or six of them in stripes, though.
So it'll be second and one.
Boy, they set up to stop the run when Kenny's in.
Simonton in the backfield, trips to the left side. Terrence Bryant comes to the left side. Hushman Zada avoided one tackler and now a flag. We'll see. Could be a hold.
They called some kind of penalty on Monjero Jones.
LeVar Rainey came up to make the stop. Hushman Zada had absolutely nothing but white shirts in front of him once he caught it. Made a nifty move to actually get close to the first down. But I think we're going to have a hold here that will bring it back.
Well, you know, Oregon State went into two tight ends right there.
Pushing the back.
Went into two tight ends, and that told, as you look at Dennis Erickson, he's a little disturbed with these penalties. These have hurt the Beavers big time today. What the Beavers have done, let's see. I disagree with that, Scott. The contact was made. The guy was facing forward. The guy spins. That can't be a call. Otherwise, everybody just turns when they make contact.
The end of the play.
Yeah.
Perhaps he just saw the end of it.
You know, the official sees the end of it. That's a tough call, I guess, on him. But he gets paid to see the start of it, not the end of it.
So it's now second down at 11. Beavers have to get to the 10 for the first.
Five
receivers
people.
Again.
Look for the draw here in this situation. Terrence runs it awfully well.
Oh, you're good, Steve, but he doesn't have room to go here. Had it for a moment, but then all those white shirts converged and Terrence had nowhere to go.
Well, that was not a call draw. He just saw that people were covered. He didn't quite wait long enough and took it right there. So now the Beavers are in a third long. I'm sure they'll be in five receivers because that's where the mismatch is.
Corey Middlebrooks, the sophomore one-year letter winner, made the stop there, number 58. Played a lot of young guys, and you can see they may be a little smaller, but they are game, and they are gamers. And Georgia Southern now trying to stop Oregon State.
Well, there are five defensive backs in now. They've helped the linebacker out a bit. Got five DBs. Let's see if we still see a post corner.
Bryant in trouble, gonna go down. Beavers are gonna have to try a long field goal. As Bryant goes down, Dante Harrow makes the tackle. He had a career high 11 tackles against Jacksonville State in his first career start, later injured a knee, was out for much of the season, but he has 11 tackles on the year coming into this one and gets it right here.
Well, that was a called draw, Scott. They'd actually called the draw right there, but it came from the outside. Terrence didn't have any time to show pass.
Seska, the true freshman, coming on to try a long field goal. Be about a 43-yarder. Georgia Southern calls timeout before he can line up to do it. Going to let the freshman think about it just a little bit here.
Well, he's got plenty of leg to make this kick. There's no question about that. Good snap, good hold, and he'll make the kick.
One for two this year. Had one blocked at Nevada when there was a low snap. Made a 21-yarder against Fresno State last week, so this would be a career-long attempt as he gets ready to go. We'll do so after the timeout. Tuesday night, of course, is our next Seattle Mariner game. Our coverage begins at 6:30 with Mariners warm-up. Chat with Skipper Lou Piniella and featured Mariner players. See what's happening around the major leagues. And then the game in Kansas City will follow. Tuesday at 6:30 on Fox Sports Net Northwest. Scott Lynn and Steve Priest with you here in Corvallis. Beautiful sunny day. Blue skies all around, but the fans wearing the orange and black here in Corvallis a little bit stunned as Georgia Southern is even with Oregon State. Now Seska to try a 43-yarder. Roddy Tompkins the holder. And I think you're right, Steve. He's got plenty of leg to do it. There's very little wind. It's down. He's got the distance. And it is good. A career-long 43-yard field goal for Ryan Seska, the freshman from Manhattan Beach, California, Miracosta High School, and he gives the Beavers a three-point lead. But we've seen field goals alone are not going to make the difference here today. But the Beavers again lead. 9 minutes left still in the first half, 24-21. Minutes, 11 seconds left here in the first half. Oregon State leading 24-21 after the 43-yard field goal by Ryan Seska. And here's Seska now to kick it off. This one's going to go down to about the 3-yard line. This is Zren Walden, and the Beavers do a pretty good job of stopping that. Zren Walden. Spelled Z-Z-R-E-A-M, Zren Walden, with a pretty good return. He is stopped there by Terrell Roberts. That is not a misspelling. It's, and no, he's not sleeping. That's his first name, Zren Walden.
Well, the Beavers have stopped Georgia Southern once so far today.
First down and 10, ball at the 23 of Georgia Southern. And the Beavers stopped that one in a hurry. Gain of maybe one.
Well, the Beavers, with the exception of one play, have shut this fullback down real tough. The one play they missed, there was a great, as you look at Aaron Wells, there was a great block on Jonathan Jackson on the touchdown by the left guard and left tackle. They hit him together. Part of that is big splits. They split out so far and they got the Beavers in the right defense that they didn't have to go by a defensive guard or tackle or end to get to the middle linebacker.
In total offense today, the Beavers are almost double the Eagles. But the score is a whole lot closer than that. Option, pitch, Peterson knocked out of bounds. Beavers defend that pretty well. Jonathan Jackson forced him out, but pretty good containment there.
No question.
They strung it out all the way to the sidelines.
Well, you know, we talked about Jonathan Jackson being responsible for the fullback. He had to make the play on the end of the line of scrimmage. You see Jonathan right there. He's mirroring the fullback. He'll come outside. You see him 39. He's following it and following it, waiting for the cutback. Now there's the pitch. Bang, there he is. So good job.
Third down and two. And this is a situation where certainly the Eagles have to get the first or they will punt it away.
Absolutely.
Peterson, the fullback. Hill looking to throw. He's got room to run. Does throw. This could be picked off. It is incomplete. The pass was intended for Chris Johnson, but Dennis Weathersby was back there, the redshirt freshman, making his third straight start since Ricky Walker is out with that injury still. He might be back, by the way, by the USC game. But certainly Weathersby's done a nice job at the corner, and he almost had the pick there.
Well, absolutely had it. Did a very good job. Let's see where the quarterback puts it. Nice job. This is Chris Johnson. That's a receiver. He's got two. Oh, yeah. Nice play. Great defensive back and stopped an interception right there. But quarterback threw it well. Weathersby was perfect coverage. Excellent job there.
And here's the punt by Chambers. Yes, he punts and kicks. Fair catch called for. And he did get the sign. Mongero Joe says, hey, did you get it or not? Flag on the play here.
He signaled for fair catch and then could see people bearing in on him. I can't imagine. They got to put that flag back in their pocket.
I've got to think so. But we will let them discuss it a bit.
Well, you know, he didn't signal until the end. Oh, my gosh.
45-yard punt by Chambers. This is only the fifth time they've had to punt in three games, Steve.
Wow.
They usually run it right down the field and score.
I tell you, Chambers punting before the game, he's got a great leg. He can kick a field goal from 60 or more. But from the punting side of it, he didn't
hit
it.
Illegal block on the back on the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Illegal block in the back right there. There's another 15. Wow.
Well, penalties and drop passes early have been the big story, I think, of this football game.
Well, they drop passes early. I think the Beavers still scored. Didn't they score on both the drop passes?
Back to the 15.
I'm trying to recall.
I'm trying to recall. I know they did on one of them.
Yeah, they did on one.
Second one, I'm not sure. Now the Beavers are tucked back in. But, you know, they still got a first down and 10 yards to go. So if they win first downs here with Terrence Bryant in the football game, let's see if they can win on first down.
Terrence Bryant trips to the right side. Simon to the running back. He gets the football. There's a big hole. Simonton around the corner. 30, 40. And he is knocked out of bounds. Earthwind Moreland makes the stop. And that's the fastest man on the team, stopping Oregon State's most dangerous running back.
Well, Kenny Simonton just, again, great vision. Good blocking, but great vision. If you take a look here, good block. He, first of all, he evades a big blitz there. Look at the good job by Robert Prescott. Good job by T.J. Hushmanday. Whatever it is.
Bushman's on him.
That Earthwind makes the play outside.
108 yards rushing now for Simonton. Up over 100 yards again. That's another 100-yard game. And he's got it again. Busting through in a hurry was 99, Vonsilius Allen. Vonsilius Allen, this guy that makes the tackle there on Simonton, number 99. He is a smart, smart guy. He's a great nose tackle, first team All-American, 1AA, and I say smart, I mean it. A 3.62 GPA in chemistry.
Whoa.
Wow. Team chemistry, I understand. I'm not sure about chemistry.
Well, he's a heck of a football player. Stays low to the ground, playing real well. Now the Beavers got Eric Mobley in the game. Kenny needs a rest. The Beavers have been blowing Kenny with five receivers, but not here. This is another running back.
Under pressure, Bryant can run. He gets very close to the first down. I'll tell you what, he just got it. Knew where he had to go. Needed to get to the 46. He ran out of bounds at the 45.
Well, great athleticism, and that's what Terrence brings to the game. He's a little bit quicker than Jonathan, and just an excellent job. Very, very poised here. He sees it's covered. Got pressure again from the same guy we talked about, Vonsilius, the chemist. He forces him to the outside, and a good job by Terrence Bryant.
He can certainly run. We saw that a year ago. We mentioned earlier, 8 starts for Terrence Bryant. Also can throw the football. Had a couple of touchdown runs to go with his 4 TD passes last year. And there might have been the call draw to the quarterback, Bryant.
It was.
And that's about an 8-yard pickup. Football on the turf, and Georgia Southern has it. Fumble, Terrence Bryant, and recovered by Georgia Southern.
Well, you know, Terrence got hit pretty good there, and he just hasn't played a lot.
And Jason Neese, number 31, is the man who came up with the football.
Well, you know, call draw. There's no question this is a call. Look at, he just takes one step back and tucks. See, he looks, now he tucks. He wasn't doing anything but running there. He's got in an option position. Now let's see where he goes down.
Georgia Southern.
Oh, yeah, it's loose.
Definitely
good job
loose
there by Neese. Now let's see if the Beavers can come back here. They got a situation where, oh, it's a little bit different set, a slot set.
Another look for Georgia Southern. Looks like their players are kind of confused with it. Quarterback keeps it. Hill picks up two or three before he's stopped. Jonathan Jackson was in on it as they came right up the middle. Jackson's to the bottom of the pile there.
Well, the Beavers have just played a miserable game as far as penalties are concerned. Well, you see it right here. Drop passes, two of them were both big passes for touchdowns dropped. Penalties, 6 for 70 yards. They've had 9 all season so far, Scott. This is crazy. Now one fumble. Beavers defense has to make some plays now. Stop this team when the team gets good position.
Second down play. Peterson, the fullback, giving the ball, and he is stopped immediately. Gain of about 1. Fans want some late stuff going on. No flags down, though. It'll just be a third down play coming up.
Well, you know, that's what's causing part of the Beavers' problem, and that is that the Beaver defensive players are getting sick of the late hits. This is a team that is trying to make something happen, trying to win up a division. They want to prove how tough they are. They're outmanned size-wise, and they're doing some things that aggravate the Beavers, and the Beavers can't start thinking about it. They got to play their defense.
Third and 4. Got to get across the 50. There's the pitch. Beavers covered. Allen had him. Down he goes. It'll be fourth down coming up. Terrence Carroll came up and popped him. Allen was the first to get a hand on him and slowed him down a bit.
Well, it's fourth and 3. These guys might want to run it again. Take a look.
We're going to wait and see. Let's take another look at the last play, Steve.
Well, nice job here. Watch the move by this guy. He sets it up, comes inside, tries to get out. Nice play by James Allen right there. When you're the only one, you got to make sure you make the play.
They are going to punt it after all. The special teams unit comes on in a hurry.
There's the kicks that he made.
Chambers kicks it. It's out of bounds. Monjero Jones was coming up to give chase, but it's out of bounds.
Well, those are the kind of kicks he was getting off before the game. Great kicker, has a little trouble punting the football.
Minutes left here in the first half. Oregon State leading Georgia Southern 24-21. Jonathan Smith back in at quarterback after Terrence Bryant had the football in charge of the team the last couple of drives. Bryant, of course, fumbled on the last play, but he had a chance on the ball, and there's a pass complete to Robert Prescott, stopped by Earthwind Moreland. We're here at Research Stadium in Corvallis, Oregon, home of the Oregon State Beavers of the Pac-10 Conference. Scott Lynn, along with Steve Priest with you. We hope you're enjoying the game. Been lots of offense, but there's a lot of stuff going on too, hasn't it?
I'll tell you, and Oregon State is making a big mistake leaving Georgia Southern in this game with mistakes. The Beavers have been penalized, dropped touchdown passes, and everything. One guy who's been very consistent is right there.
Ken Simonton, over 100 yards rushing today. Short of the first down, got out to the 38-yard line, be about 3 yards shy of the first down. This is his 7th career game of 100 yards rushing in just, what, his 14th career start? Is that right?
That's it. And, you know, you don't want him to have to carry the ball 35 times today. You want to get this game over, and the Beavers' defense has got to come to it and come to the fore while the offense plays the kind of game they've been playing for the first quarter and a half.
5 receivers on this 3rd and 3 play.
Nickel Jonathan defense.
Smith. Yep, you're right. 5 DBs.
The mismatch is down here at the bottom now.
Percoats on the slant. Got it. First down out to the 40.
Big body again. Jonathan Smith puts that ball in between 2 guys, and the big guy makes the catch. Yeah, I tell you, that is a great catch. When we see that, Jonathan lays it right where he has to lay it. There are 2 guys all over him. There's your mismatch. Watch this. Zap. He's going to get hit, and he's nailed pretty good by a very good cornerback as well. Just really good execution. There he is, Imani Percoats.
Percoats goes wide to the right side as the Beavers put 3 receivers on that side. Simonton back into the running back. Inside 4 minutes left. First half, Beavers leading by 3. Smith going long, it would appear. Got a guy, Hushmanzada. He's got it inside the 25 to the 24-yard line. TJ Hushmanzada brought down by the strong safety, Ryan Haddon. And you talked about it earlier, the mismatch with that strong safety.
Yeah, that's a big deal. You saw it before the play. I think Jonathan checks off, but Jonathan runs a misdirection play here. Good job by Ken Simonton of throwing the block. And you can see, if the pass is on the money right there, it's a touchdown. TJ just beat that safety real bad. And, you know, folks, I can tell you, when you're a safety out there and you got about a three-step cushion on the guy to stay even with him, you're in trouble when the guy's got time, when the quarterback's got time to throw.
Bushmanzada takes a quick breather. Roddy Tompkins in for him as the Beavers continue to shuffle receivers. This is Simonton, another big hole, that line opening him up. He gets five or six inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. Ken Simonton, if you'll recall, close to a 200 yards rushing in each of the first two games. And quite honestly, he could do it very easily here today, but the Beavers would just as soon he not have to play that much.
Well, yeah, I'd like to see from the Beavers' perspective. Heck, you're almost at half, and the Beavers are up by 3 points. Now, you know, you go in at halftime, and they're giving Coach Johnson a real lot to talk about in that Georgia Southern locker room. The Beavers need to – oh, whoa. That was a cute little forward roll by the wide receiver. Tripped on Reeser.
Tripped on the turf as he headed out to his spot. Hand off Simonton. Stop, flag on the play, probably holding.
It's a hold inside, no question.
Would be short of the first down by about a yard and a half, but they'll probably bring it back.
Well, there, you know, I think I saw Jason's back in. Vincent Sandoval was in at the left tackle spot earlier in this drive, 74, but Jason is back. He's got to be holding. And that was a second down and five. The Beavers, both sides of the ball, have to win first down. That means 4 yards or better, whether you're offensive, defensive. If you're offensive, you want more than four. If you're defensive, you want less than four. Beavers have pretty well won it from the offensive side. They've done it on defense, except for the big plays.
Mark Walsh comes
holding
in.
On the offense, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay second down.
Walsh replacing Benny Johnson at the tight end spot on this play coming up. But there's 10 yards that puts the Beavers back to the 28-yard line. There's Jason White, the left tackle, senior, one-year letter winner, former junior college All-American out of Diablo Valley College. Originally signed with Michigan State, but didn't get his junior college degree in time to make that happen. Ends up at Oregon State. Beavers happy to have him. He's been a good one the last year and a half.
And Eric Mobley in the game now. He's been doing mostly swing running. There he is, open.
To Mobley. Mobley on the sideline, about 4 yards shy of the first down. Gets inside the 20 before the right corner, Earthwind Moreland, comes up to stop him.
Nice play by Eric. Now here, you can see he took a shot in the knee, but I like what I see. He runs the play right. Watch Jonathan deliver it. Now, when he gets down there, he knows he's going for a first down. He's hemmed in. He just lines up and comes upfield. I think TJ right there made the wrong decision. I think he should have turned around right there, but you know, he did go after a block. He got a block with a guy chasing, left it to Eric to beat the one guy one-on-one, and he went for the first down.
Simonton back in at the running back. Has the football, got close to the first down, got tripped up. I don't think he got it.
I don't think he got the first down either, but I think he made a heck of an effort, and I hope Dennis Erickson goes for the touchdown here.
Well, I think Dennis will, to be honest with you.
You know, you really don't want to give or go into half with another field goal. You need this score. You really do, and if you don't, you're in excellent field position.
Fourth down and one. The fans cheered the decision as Smith went over to the sideline, talked it over briefly with the coach. Now the Beavers will take it. Fourth down, and it's a short one. It's only about a foot or two. Tompkins wide to the right. Percoats to the left. Simonton the running back. You know they're going to hand to Simonton, don't you? There it is. He's got the first down, I believe, depending on the spot. He easily has it, but you always have to wait.
Yeah, absolutely. That was a nice surge by the Beavers, and Ken Simonton knows where he has to go to get it. That's a first down.
Beaver first down with a minute left here in this first half. Oregon State with a pretty nice drive here. You really, if you're wearing orange and black here in Corvallis today, you're rooting for them to get in.
Well, that's it. The Beavers right here. You know, if they can get into the end zone, get seven, and then not have something silly happen in the last few seconds, it's a pretty healthy position. Right now, they got a situation where they can come this side, and they got a pretty good run with Ken Simonton right here.
Simonton up the middle. End zone is mine, says Ken Simonton. Touchdown, number 35, his third of the day.
Well, I tell you, Jonathan Smith, is just doing a great job of knowing where to take that football. You could see the hole in the defense anywhere in the stadium, and this guy knows what to do with it.
Look at those numbers, Steve. I got to tell you right now, and I made this earlier comment on radio in Portland this week, if Simonton continues to get the kind of numbers he's getting, he will appear on my Heisman ballot. I have a vote, and he will be on my ballot if he keeps those kind of numbers up.
Well, I can't believe he wouldn't appear right now on your Heisman
ballot. Seska delivers the point after, and the Beavers stretch their lead to 10. Jonathan Smith breathing just a little easier.
Wait. He put it on that safety. Ow!
The 10-point advantage, 31-21. Simonton with his third touchdown run of the game. And again, we'll let you know that Simonton is over 100 yards, fourth straight game, tying the OSU record of Pete Pfeiffer.
There must be a wind up there because he really isn't getting it very deep.
And there's a pretty good return. Out to about the 35 by Anthony Williams. There's Simonton. Another big day, 10 plays, 74 yards, 4.5 minutes. Excellent drive for the Beavers. 12-yard run by Simonton, capping it off. And let's take another look at it.
Well, just watch the blocking on this side of the line. They knock people out. Now look at the headache. Here comes the free safety. Ouch. He just...
Oh, my.
Folks, that's a vulnerable position. Well, the guy's got 2 yards to go. You got nothing to do here. Now let's see if this team runs it in the ground, runs their option, or whether they throw the football.
Going to throw right here. Greg Hill got a guy open, and it is a catch. Nicely done by Chris Johnson. Johnson, who caught 3 passes a week ago for a team-high 111 yards, with a catch here. He had 2 long touchdown catches last week, and just like that, with 22 seconds left here in this first half, Georgia Southern getting within position get a touchdown.
Scott, that quarterback or cornerback has him completely covered. And the quarterback throws it in and makes a pretty decent play. Same there.
Gerard Freeman, the slot guy, makes the catch. Out of bounds. Clock stops. 15 on the scoreboard clock. And Greg Hill shows, hey, look, I can throw the ball. I just don't like to.
Yeah. You know, you wonder, the kicker's got a great leg. Now, remember that. This kicker can right now make a field goal, Chris Chambers. He can kick it from there, even though it'd be 55, 57 yards. So they're going to go for touchdown. They're going to take a couple of shots at touchdown right here.
Coming this way, going to the end zone, and it's overthrown. A couple of receivers in the area. Chris Johnson was one of them. But they actually had 2 guys, I think, running the pattern there.
Well, in this situation, you know, the guy can kick it this far, but what you want to do, I think, as a coach, is you try to complete something for the first down. That's 4 yards. That gives you an automatic timeout and puts you in a position to kick a field goal.
And they
try to get out of here with 3.
They still have the 1 timeout as well. But I think you're right, Steve. You just set up a chance. Or are they going to take another shot at the end zone? Looks like they're going to the sidelines. Incomplete. 4 seconds left, so they will have an opportunity on the final play to kick a long field goal. And again, what wind there is seems to be blowing at the back of the kicker coming up here, and he's been able to find the end zone on the kickoffs. So let's see if Chambers can do it. Now, Chris Chambers has not attempted a field goal this year. Last year, however, he was 12 of 14 during the regular season. He has never attempted a 50-yarder in his career.
Well, from watching this guy before the game, he can kick it a mile.
The spot's on the 47. This is a 57-yarder.
Interesting setup here, looking for the long block on the outside.
He's got leg. He may have the distance. He does. It's good! 57 yards! Chris Chambers! And the first half comes to an end, and all momentum here goes to Georgia Southern. Wow, high fives around for Chris Chambers. The longest field goal of his career. Got to be a school record, I would think.
Oh, absolutely.
57 yards. And heading to the locker room, the Eagles of Georgia Southern are just 1 touchdown behind Oregon State. Stick around, long way to go. Welcome back to Corvallis, Oregon, Reser Stadium, where Oregon State is leading Georgia Southern 31-24. The team that's leading right now was kind of expected, but it's a lot closer than a lot of people thought here, including my partner Steve.
Well, the Beavers are out rushing a rushing wishbone team. They got 417 yards of total offense. They're dominating, but they made some bonehead mistakes on kickoff return, on a couple of penalties, on a couple of drop touchdown passes. It's a tight game. The Beavers better pick it up.
All right, let's check out some of those first half highlights. And Steve, in a 31-24 game, you got highlights.
Well, this is a fourth and one, and this is Greg Hill. He just makes a great play, big play. There have been three big plays, four counting the kickoff return, that have turned it around for this team. There's the touchdown after that play. A good situation for this Georgia Southern team. Here's Jonathan Smith. Watch this catch and run by Mongero Jones. Beavers coaches have been waiting for Mongero to come along. All three junior college receivers have now come to the fore and had some great games. Now, this is the man, Kenny Simonton, over 140 yards already in the first half. As we said, the Beavers are offensively doing what they're supposed to be doing, not defensively.
And there are the numbers that you were talking about, Steve. First downs, the Beavers 18-8. Total yards, 417-184. The Beavers have the football 19 minutes compared to 11 for Georgia Southern. And yet it's a one-touchdown football game. And, of course, the SNS show, the Smith and Simonton show, it's again awfully good. Smith 10 out of 15, 200 yards passing. Simonton 21 carries, 137 yards, three touchdowns. What do you think he might have said at halftime, Steve? I'll bet you he maybe got their attention a little bit.
Well, it's X-rated, Scott. I can tell you that. This is a guy who told me before the game this was scary. This was scary to him because you just don't prepare your team and tell them, hey, you better be ready for these guys because they are able to score big time. You can tell your kids that, but they know how many scholarships Georgia Southern has. They know how many of these guys were recruited by the big schools. They know they should be winning, and now they're getting it handed to them a little bit.
First half possessions for the Eagles. Touchdown. They lost the downs. Had another touchdown and a couple of punts. Really a situation here with that 57-yard field goal to end the first half. Gives them a great position and momentum as Georgia Southern gets the football here to start the second half and a chance to go right down the field and tie it. First half passing, 3 of 7, 51 yards, 5 rushes, 50 yards. For Hill, who's coming out throwing. Now he's going to run, tucks the football away, and he's going to get out of bounds before he gets hit by James Allen.
Well, you know, that's an example of great speed helping out. Greg Hill, who has great speed, as you look at Greg right there, he has an opening. Oregon State covers the pass very well. I like the little wrinkle by Georgia Southern, figuring the Beavers are charged up. I'm going to make a statement at the start of the second half. He gets open, and James Allen just makes it an easy play. Gives him a one-yard gain. Beavers control first down there.
Second and nine. Hill behind center. The hand, nope, it's the option. The quarterback still has it. And he still makes first down. Got across the 30. That was where he needed to go for the first down. Gets to the 32. Brought down by Darnell Robinson. But here is Hill, a guy who is averaging 9 yards per carry and 92 yards per game on the ground just with his wheels. And, yes, number 10, you might recall, very similar to number 10 he used to play here at Oregon State, Tim Alexander.
Well, he was wide open there. Somebody missed an assignment. Somebody was over-aggressive on the end of the Beaver line. I looked to see, Tolai is in there at the right end position right now. Looks like they're going to run it again. There's a good play.
The Beavers do not stop him until he gets very close to a first down. Calvin Carlisle was the first to come up and get him. And there was Benny Cunningham, who had the big kick return of 89 yards in the first half. He was the guy that got the ball on the pitch there. He's a little shaken up.
Well, he is a little shaken, but watch this. There's a good fake. Let's see. Where's the guy outside? Come on, there's got to be a defensive end out there. Defensive end can't be filling in that situation unless the Beavers were in over alignment. I don't think they were. Ow, there's a big shot on the knee by Calvin Carlisle.
Second down, one coming up here. The fullback has it. Peterson gets the first down and gets close to the 50, gets to the 49. Before he stopped, Jonathan Jackson, number 39, there at the bottom of the pile. But another first down. And the one thing that Georgia Southern has proven is that these guys have some skills.
Well, you see rushing defense, 68 yards average for the Beavers. For for today, 158 already. Wow, that's amazing, folks. The Beavers have not handled this the way they should have, and now a big momentum situation at the start of the second half. Big momentum.
Hill audibilizes, I think, at the line of scrimmage, and he hands to Peterson, the fullback, busted through for about four or five. Atole Talataina grabbed him, number 51, and held on, the three-year letter winner out of Hawaii.
This offense has averaged 8.2 yards per first down for this season. That's phenomenal. That's how you control the ball. Now, the Beavers held him to about 4 yards right there, which is right on, kind of the number. You try to hold him to less, it looks like it's right at. So, Beavers need to stop this drive.
Quarterback flips. Ball on the turf, and the Beavers are going to recover. Jonathan Jackson picks up the football, falls on it, and the Beavers, with the momentum perhaps changing in their favor early in the second half.
Well, you know, right now the Beavers have to turn this game around, and this is a team that was plus three. Georgia Southern was plus three per game on this fumble turnover situation, but there was a nice job by the Beavers. They forced the quick pitch. It was a bad pitch, if you will, and the Beavers get a turnover.
The Beavers actually plus three, Steve. Actually, Georgia Southern even better. Eight takeaways and just two turnovers.
Wow.
They were plus six after their first two games. But a big one there, and Smith now pitches to Simonton. Simonton blasted just as he gets to midfield.
That's a little wrinkle the Beavers have shown three times this game already. That little toss to Kenny Simonton. First two games, Kenny took it mostly straight ahead, but just trying to get him outside a little bit quicker.
Josh Smithers, number 33, came up to put the stop on him there. One of the linebackers, senior linebacker.
He's made a lot of tackles today. Smithers.
Here's Smith. Simonton in the backfield. Two receivers to the left side. Put Coates wide to the right. Looking left over the middle. Prescott caught it for the first down. He's brought back inside, outside the 40. Ryan Haddon grabbed him and pulled him back, but with his forward progress, he's going to have the first down.
This is a nice job. It's just a clear out. Take a look at this guy, Robert Prescott. He's going to go down and across. Outside man's just going to take it deep. Jonathan just looks down there, waits till he's open. This looks like man-on-man coverage. See, where's that guy in the backfield? He's afraid to get close, folks. That's number 12 again. He's a strong safety, and he hadn't got the speed to be playing these receivers. He's lined up at 12 yards, and that should be like taking
Kenny right on the turf. And I think Smith got back on it. Now, reminder, DiDomenico back in his first game of the year working with Smith. Now, you shouldn't have any trouble with the exchange, maybe just a little over-anxious there. But DiDomenico, the normal starting center, last year, he and Smith certainly have had their share of exchanges. Shouldn't be a problem there.
Well, no problem. I mean, again, that's one time in three games. I think we've seen it. But, again, you're right. Chris Gibson has been doing an excellent job at center in Keith's absence.
Gibson, of course, suffered a knee injury against Fresno State last week. Little screen for Simonton. Busts one tackle and gets a little something out of him. There wasn't much there. And he gets about three or four to the 35-yard line. But it's going to be short of the first. Third down coming up.
Well, I'm surprised there. Downfield, Robert Prescott had his helmet just yanked off by a cornerback. These kids, that was Kawaki Thomas that did it. And the kids from Georgia Southern are really stretching the limits of things, trying to get some shots in. This is their chance for an upset to do some things like that. But the officials need to call some things right now in the secondary.
Mobley in the backfield now. Simonton gets a breather on this third down and six.
Corner down here out of the slot has got to be a gift.
Smith looking, throws for Hushmanzada. He makes a tremendous catch. Stays on his feet, fights to the 15. First down for the Beavers.
I tell you, that's three or four catches today. Throws by Jonathan Smith, where Jonathan absolutely puts it in a place nobody can get it but the receiver. And then he's gotten three or four great catches, one by Prescott, couple by Percoats, and that one by TJ. Now let's look at TJ. Here he is. He's coming across the middle. Now watch this. He drills it. Earthwind Moreland just has him covered. Wow, that's a great job. Big target again. Watch him keep going. You watch Jonathan Smith. Bonselli's had a pretty good rush going there but fell down. Bang. Nice play by the
Smith.
Smith.
He's taking a shot there. Also a player down and being helped off the field right now. Kewaukee Thomas, the starting right left corner.
And Kewaukee's a real valuable player at both corners. They're, I think, two of their three best players on this defense are their two cornerbacks, and they have enough trouble in the secondary. Their nickelback is their today's starting safety, and they don't have any people to come out and play the corner. Number four. No, Earthwind, excuse me, other side, 14. They moved Earthwind over to this side. They brought in Nate Gates, a junior.
Cousin of Billy Galt, as a matter of fact, Gates is. Got some good genes, and here's a guy with some genes, but nothing as far as running room on that play is pretty well defended by the entire team. Arky Thompson comes up from a free safety spot, but also a number 33, Josh Smithers again. The coaches here talk about this guy. They say, hey, he's an overachiever. He just always works his way back up the depth chart. He always starts spring football or the fall down about third or fourth on the team, and I'll be darned if he doesn't work his way right back up. Got a start against Fayetteville State in the season opener.
Well, he made some big plays today, and the Beavers have run that same play on two consecutive first downs and got nothing out of it, one to each side.
And that's the first time that Simonton has been dropped for a loss today. Five receivers, Smith, picking and choosing. Throws in and out of the hands of Hushmanzada.
That's three touchdowns the Beavers have dropped today. That's a touchdown if TJ catches it, and that's three. You know, folks, these coaches expect these receivers to catch everything. You can touch it, you can catch it. So that may have looked like a tough catch, but it's in Tim Lapana, who's the receivers coach coordinator, it's his idea that you catch it maybe if you could touch it. That's what this system is built on.
Smith pointing right at Hushmanzada. Let's see if he comes back the other the right side. Again, another five receiver set. Tompkins wide right. Hushmanzada in the middle of the trips to the right side. Monjero Jones is also to the right side as a receiver. And now a flag. And is it too long for Oregon State? I believe they took too much time, and it's going to cost them 5, 3rd and 16 coming up.
5-yard penalty, still third down.
Well, you know, Scott, sometimes if there's ever a penalty that doesn't hurt you, it's at about the 15-yard line.
Gives you a little more room to operate.
It does. I'm concerned that they got fourth down over there showing, but other than that.
On the sideline marker, but now it's third down.
Well, right here, I look for Oregon State to go at number 12. Who's ever out here, 12 cannot cover any one of these three guys at the bottom of the screen.
And right now he's lined up against Hushmanzada. That's who Smith's looking at. Hushmanzada had to go down to try to get it, could not. And it's going to be fourth down, and Seska is going to come on to try a field goal.
Well, pass was too low. Wide open. See right here, Jonathan delivers. He's hit some great ones. Again, that's a play that would have been a great play, but he's wide open, and that guy is beaten like a drum again. Should be a big play, and if the pass is delivered right, it's at least first down.
37-yard field goal attempt coming up by Seska. The hold is good. The kick is up, and it is no good. Off to the left. And the momentum could be swinging to the side of the Eagles as they hold on Oregon State's first possession of the second half. The Eagles will get it back, trailing by a touchdown. Just inside 9 minutes left here in the third quarter, Oregon State continues to lead Georgia Southern 31-24. But after the missed 37-yard field goal attempt by Ryan Seska, the Eagles now have the football and a chance to tie. And Greg Hill goes back to run things one more time. In the 1998 1AA championship game against UMass, this guy carried 29 times for 228 yards, also threw for 111 yards, accounted for three touchdowns in the losing effort.
Well, he can do it, and you know, the Beavers had a good opportunity right there. They've got 452 yards of total offense to about 150 for the other side, or 175, and they're just playing real well, but they got a chance right there defensively to get a first down where they had a chance to score, and the Beavers needed some points right there. They needed to take it in, had the opportunities, and a drop pass stopped it.
Greg Hill, 21-2 as a starter for the Georgia Southern Eagles. He ran or passed for 52 touchdowns in just over 2 years as the regular quarterback coming into this game. And he's done a nice job helping Georgia Southern be very much in this football game in Pac-10 territory. And he's going to throw here on first down. Beavers putting pressure on. He throws it, and it is incomplete. Calvin Carlisle was defending on the play.
Well, I think that's both series, and in fact, three first downs this second half that this Georgia Southern team has come out with the fake and gotten back, tried to throw the football. Obviously, coach can see Oregon State's people coming, so he's going to mix it up a little bit.
Paul Johnson, in his third year as the head coach of the Georgia Southern Eagles. Postseason record, 4-2. That's pretty good. Remember, again, 1AA football. They have playoffs, and his team made it to the championship game a year ago. The sixth time that the school's been in the championship game, they've won it four times. Peterson, the ball carrier, busts up for about five.
Looks like Tolai was in on that play.
Coming in from the number 51.
Leaves the field now, but he came in, just folded in from the right side end position. Looks like Kyle Rossell now has come in for Tolai.
And now running in at one of the wide receiver spots is Chris Johnson, who was the favorite target a week ago of Hill. Now third down and six. Peterson's first half totals, 10 rushes, 66 yards. Again, he's got a string of 17 consecutive games of 100 yards or more. Under great pressure.
Green.
Hill now going to get rid of the football and does. The screen they attempted to set up.
They got to throw a flag. They had a lineman downfield several yards. Oregon State had it covered real well, but no flag.
DeLawrence Grant coming in there, putting the pressure on it. I want to give Grant where credit is due. Grant was the guy a week ago who tipped a pass up in the air that Darnell Robinson caught, ran it in for a touchdown. We couldn't tell by any of the replays, couldn't tell at the time who actually made that big defensive play, but it was number one, DeLawrence Grant. So a week later, we give you credit where it's due.
Well, you see the punting average, it isn't good. He's got a great leg, but I don't think he punts well.
Ushman Zada, given room to catch it, takes it at the 38, retreats a bit, trying to find some room, spins out to the 45.
What?
And that's a pretty good move before he's stopped by Nate Gates.
Awfully close to a big play. Good field position by the Beavers here, 45. Good job. Good start.
Oregon State leading by a touchdown, and now once again with the ball. Seven minutes, 49 seconds left here in the third quarter. Oregon State now with the football for the second time here in the third quarter. Missed a field goal the first time they had the football, but now having the ball at about the 45-yard line to start this possession. Smith to throw, and it is picked off! Interception right there by number five, Archie Thompson. Thompson with his second interception of the year, and the Beavers have a player down. Mongero Jones, was it?
Mongero, yeah.
Mongero Jones shaken up on the play, but the interception by Archie Thompson moved in as the starting free safety. Here's a guy who missed all of spring football with a shoulder after shoulder surgery, and he comes up with the pick. Look at him play
right
center
here.
Field.
He is just playing man free right down the middle. In fact, that's what he was a man free, not a zone, and he just is there all the way. I don't think Jonathan read it correctly as you look at the streak, 63 passes without an interception ends. And now, Beavers got to step up on defense and make another play. They've done it for 2 weeks defensively. Let's see what they do here.
Beavers have normally stepped it up in the second half, and here's the pitch to the fullback, Peterson. Still on his feet! Carlisle has to bring him down inside the 40. Adrian Peterson trying for another 100-yard game. Almost got it right there.
Well, that looked like a play that was nothing there, and somehow it turned out to be a very good football play. I thought the Beavers had it absolutely stopped, but the pitch man isn't there. Look at that. Nice block on the outside. Good job downfield. Good job right there. There's got to be a hold. He can't get loose. But by the same token, nice job by the running back of freeing himself up to make some yards. Now the Beavers need to step up and stop it.
Adrian Peterson. 18 career games, and now he moved. You saw him right there, and he's still down on the ground. No, he says I went a little too soon, a little too excited about getting the 100-yard game. He's up over 100 yards now, 18 consecutive games. And, of course, here's a guy. He's been something special. a career-high 232-yard game against Connecticut last season. He started all 15 games counting the playoffs, but in the regular season, get this, Steve, 25 touchdown runs, also had a touchdown reception. And that's just the regular season numbers in 11 games.
What is he, 24 points per game this year? I think that's a little bit big in its own right.
Ball in Oregon State territory, even after the penalty. Beavers stopped that one. Not much doing. Eric Manning, number 99, the true freshman out of Compton, California, comes up and makes the stop, playing in one of the tackle
spots.
Like
the way Paul Johnson mixes up his game. He's got a lot of counter stuff, trying to find out if the fullback is being covered by the middle linebacker, looking to see if people are reading direction. That really makes it tough on the safeties. They're the ones trying to scrape off and make plays, quarterback in the pitch.
Greg Hill looking right into that sun. It's the option, the pitch to one of the slot guys, and it is a nice play. Gerard Freeman is stopped, finally, by Darnell Robinson.
Pretty close to a first down.
It is very close. Going to measure it as we take another look.
Well, watch Hill run this. He does a great job of running the option. Good fake right there, right down the line of scrimmage. He sees Darnell and pitches. Nice job on the outside by the receiver. Makes an excellent play, and who wraps him up? Darnell?
Robinson came back to get him after making, stopping the quarterback initially. You can see the spot about a yard, well, a foot short. Down and one, and a short one at that.
Well, I'd be willing to bet you right here that this is an option. This, to me, with this football team, after Coach Johnson goes for it on fourth and one in the first half when it could have really been a problem, this is like four down area for him. I think we'll see something going for the bomb, and I believe it'll either be a pass or, better yet, just the option. That little option with the fullback has been wonderful, but that isn't logical.
Take
fullbacks, go outside.
I'll bet Hill keeps it ready. Let's see if we're right. Hill, 35 rushing touchdowns in his career. Third down and one, just outside the 28 of Oregon State. Hill has it, keeps it, still on his feet, to the 15. Greg Hill on the keeper.
Well, you know, the guy that's hitting Hill has just got to stay on him, got to be assignment, got to run your assignment. There's a great fullback fake in here. Watch this, this guy's going to get a fake right there. Hill fakes it, gets a good ride, and then comes down here. He sees it open, and he knows right now, Rossell, right there. Kyle Rossell has got, as a defensive end, to take the quarterback. That's his assignment. He can't lean inside. He's playing outside, and if he goes inside and hits the fullback, then there's nobody there to make that play.
And James Allen is down on the field for Oregon State. Let's hope that's just a cramp. Allen, a sophomore out of Jefferson High School. And let's see if he's going to be all right. Darnell Robinson was shaken up early in the game. He's back in and has been playing. Allen, 6'1", 219, third-year sophomore out of Portland. You know, tonight at 7 from Las Vegas, it's the Sunday Night Fights. Former WBC champ Wayne McCullough goes toe-to-toe with Lynn Martinez in a 10-round super bantamweight bout. McCullough, ranked number 2 by the WBC, a record of 22-2. Martinez, 17-5-1 with 17 KOs. Tonight at 7, right here on Fox Sports Net Northwest. There's Allen, and that does not look like a cramp.
No, it doesn't. It looks like a knee. You know, for the Beavers, and that's a big, big hurt if he's out. They've already lost 3 or 4 starters for the year, or not for the year already, but for weeks. Let's see where he comes from.
Right there, and in contact with Hill, who had just gone to the ground. And
that's kind of a knee. That was his right knee, and that just kind of rolled over.
Yeah.
Hopefully that's just an alley. Now here, big play. Beavers are out, man, going to the right side.
First down. Peterson, the ball carrier, is stopped. Beavers did a good job stopping the fullback there.
They did. Excellent job. And remember, the guys that are stopping the fullback are the guys in the middle, the defensive linemen, down linemen, in this case 49, Aaron Wells and Sean Ball or else Manning are in there. The guys that got to make the quarterback pitch are the defensive ends and the outside backers.
Kyle Rozelle is in at number 97. There's Jonathan Jackson, 39. Isaac White is now into the linebacker spot for James Allen, who's gone off with a knee injury. Second down, 9 at the 14 of Oregon State. Greg Hill and Georgia Southern trying to get there. And again, the handoff to the first man through, and the Beavers stop it. Pickup of another one maybe, but it'll be third and eight.
Beavers are doing a good job defensive line-wise in the middle, keeping their pads low. That's how the wishbone works, is you split people out and then you kind of bang them, as you see Kyle Rossell now.
He's getting up slow, isn't he?
Yep, Tolai coming in as Kyle's, again, we were just talking about it. You got to get your pads low because the wishbone, they come at your knees, folks.
I was just going to say, explain the chop block again. You can do it right at the line of scrimmage, right?
Oh, absolutely. You can do it. It's perfectly legal. It's just something defensive linemen usually don't see because most people pass. They stand up and pass blocks, get their hand up, get, you know, like basketball players. This chop block's a whole different thing.
Georgia Southern, 2 of 8 on third down conversions today. And now movement in the backfield again. Peterson moved in the backfield. And he could, it might have been that he could not hear as the crowd was very loud.
Well, that's what he's saying. He's saying he can't hear. Obviously, he turned around the quarterback and held his hands up, shook his shoulders, looked at the sideline like, can't hear it. But he's right there. You see it. I can't hear a thing.
And give the Beaver fans some credit right
ball,
there.
Ball. False nice start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
We saw that graphic on third down conversions a moment ago. Consider this. Coming into this game, Georgia Southern was good on 17 of 22 third down plays this year, 77%. But the first unit, the first teamers, 17 out of 18 on third down plays.
Well, you know, here's the situation. Now they've got more room to throw to the end zone. Let's see what happens.
Third down and 12. Hill with time, and he's got a guy, and he made the catch. Number 83, Dedrick Parham. Stopped by Isaac White, and Parham almost got to the end zone. All kinds of time for Hill.
Well, you know, that's two catches by Parham where he's actually been well covered, and the ball's thrown way behind him, and he just reaches down and catches it. Good job there by the offensive line. But you see, he's covered
nice
very
catch.
Well from the inside. Ball was thrown behind him, and he makes a great catch.
Well, we have seen today Georgia Southern has playmakers. And right now, a first and goal at the one. Movement somewhere. Let's see. It looks like, well, we'll wait. You know this guy's anxious, Paul Johnson, the head coach of the Georgia Southern Eagles. And that's against Georgia Southern. Must have been movement on the O-line.
Well, defensive line switches for the Beavers right there. Switches all across. Gives Beavers 6 yards to play with. That's big down here. That would have been an absolute gimme touchdown. Now they got some work.
It'll be first and goal at the 6. Greg Hill likes to keep the football. I know that they've gone an awful lot to Peterson today and through the season, but he'd just as soon hang on to it.
Well,
thank you.
54 touchdowns he's responsible for in his career. He likes to get into that end zone.
He has the football, pitches outside, and Peterson is out of bounds. Peterson is out of bounds at the 5. So it will be second down and goal at the 5.
You can tell he was headed up the field. He was going to go for the touchdown, and just a nice play from the inside forced a late pitch and a nice catch by Peterson. I thought for a second you had another fumble situation.
I did too. DeLawrence Grant, you saw there, part of the Beaver coverage, and they did defend it well there and needed to. 31-24, Georgia Southern, 8 plays, 66 yards on this drive, and they're knocking on the door. Greg Hill behind the center. Peterson, the only running back, maybe an audible now. Crowd hooting and hollering. Quarterback draw called by Hill. Jonathan Jackson stopped him up top. I think Darnell Robinson went down low. And it's going to be third down coming up. For a moment, it looked to me like he was going to score.
Yeah, I thought he had a touchdown when he came back there. Nice plays. You look at young Mr. Hill. He makes a nice cut here. Called all the way. He audibled this. He saw people out of the way, and he's coming back here. He's looking for this hole, and he gets it. Good job of coming back by Darnell Robinson particularly, and then Jonathan Jackson. Now you got the huge play. You got to see the option here. They bring in all linemen across the board.
And
option
it's
coming.
Here it comes. Third and goal at the one, and Hill's going to score easily. Georgia Southern is within one.
Naked
Greg
option.
Hill, naked option, third touchdown run of the season for Hill. 16 straight games he has scored a touchdown, and he's trying to get to 22-2 as a starting quarterback of Georgia Southern. Now, the point after. You can see they're already lined up, holder, kicker. The center's there ready to hike the ball. The line's off, shifted to the left, and now they'll all run over. You do that just to be safe, as we talked about earlier. Make sure they don't snap it and try to get a quick two.
Absolutely. And, you know, you...
Point after by Chambers.
They got a chance to win the football game. They could do anything.
It's up and through. Right now, the Georgia Southern Eagles out of the Southern Conference, the top-ranked 1AA team in the nation, is tied with its first-ever Pac-10 opponent, Oregon State, with just over 3 minutes left in the third quarter. 31-31. I know you're not going anywhere. The Georgia Southern Eagles have tied this football game with just over 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Tied at 31, this is a program that was resurrected just 18 years ago. They now have four Division I AA championships. They're still looking for their first win over Division I teams, and right here, 0-11. But, of course, last game got hammered pretty good by Florida, but they've played teams tough. They scared the heck out of Florida State, actually leading with 8.5 minutes left in Tallahassee back in 1988.
Well, that was a team that had Deion Sanders and Sammy Smith. That was a pretty good football team. They had Auburn 17-0 at one time on a good Auburn team. They played some other people really tough. I'll tell you, the Beavers are in a dogfight right here. Offense needs to step up and put some points on the board and watch for Georgia Southern right now to do anything to create a problem. I'm from onside kickoffs to throwing the ball on play pass. You just watch out. I would expect a lot of blitzes.
Prescott and Battle, you see, back to take the kick. It's going to be rather short, and this is going to be Battle taking it at the 12. A pretty nice return across the 25 to the 27, and Chris Blunt comes up to stop him. Dennis Erickson talking to Jonathan Smith, saying, fellas, we're in a football game.
Without a doubt.
Jonathan Smith came on at the end of last season, of course, and became a big-time player for Oregon State. Against the University of Washington, almost led the Beavers to a win at UW. A drop, tough play on the two-point conversion. That would have won it for Oregon State as time had expired. Then the last three games as the starter, did a great job for the Beavers, led Oregon State to an upset win over Oregon right here in this stadium. And now the Beavers are in a dogfight. Hushman's out on the reverse. Let's see how this develops. Good blocking. Hushman's out of cuts inside, and he gets to midfield. TJ Hushman's out on the reverse to the 49-yard line of Georgia Southern.
Nice call. We talked about it last series. The Beavers ran the toss to Ken Simonton, three straight first downs in a row, and got nothing. They ran it this time. There's the toss. Look at, great job here. Georgia Southern had eight people in the box right there expecting Simonton to run on first down. Now the Beavers got a little bit of an advantage, got themselves out of a tough position as you watch Hosman, as
TJ
gain his yards.
Simonton with it. Gain of about four, close to the 45. Well, we'll call it the 46, so he only gets three.
I'm surprised at how well that this Georgia Southern team has played first down in the second half. First half, Simonton ran at will on first down. Beavers passed at will on first down. They were probably 8-9 yards every time they touched on first down. Not so in the second half.
32 rushes, 22 passes today as far as Oregon State's play calling. Jamar Jones, outside linebacker, came up to make the stop again. He was the team's leading tackler after the first two games. He's been there today. And Simonton breaks through the hole, spins to the 25, first down for Oregon State. Great Jones catches him from behind.
Great hole right there by the offensive line on a little draw. You like to see it. Good call. See the good fake by Jonathan Smith. That takes people away, and a good broad job by Robert Sykes, 72, downfield Robert Prescott doing a good job.
How important is number 35? You talked about wanting to get him rest before the bye week, and the Pac-10 season opens 2 weeks from now at USC, but the Beavers not only want him in here now, they need him in here.
They absolutely need him.
And that was nothing. Miscommunication there.
Totally miscommunication right there. Jonathan threw a hitch. You see Jonathan heading for the sideline to talk to Dennis, but that was a missed communication. DJ was running a deep pattern right there. He was bump and run, so I'm surprised Jonathan tried to throw that. Maybe he was just getting rid of the ball. You don't bump and run a hitch on an audible.
Imani Percoats goes wide to the left side. Prescott to the left side as well. Hushmanzada wide right. Benny Johnson, the tight end. Eric Nobling, the running back right here on the second down 10 play. Looking to throw. Will Percoats. Looks like he was held up heading to the end zone. No call. Earthwind Moreland was back there defending. There was some contact, but the official was right there and said no flag. Percoats had the big second half last week, and it looked like they were calling his number right here.
Well, these corners are good. You watch them, Earthwind and as well as two. They both play bump and run real well. They got great speed. I believe he had the 4.28. No, he had a, yeah, he's 4.3. The guy on the other side is 4.4 speed, so they can play.
Roddy Tompkins now in wide right. Prescott and Percoats to the left. Simonton, the running back. Draw, Simonton. The hole closed. And I believe once again, Josh Smithers, 33, came up and grabbed an ankle. If so, what an impact he's had today.
Well, this is interesting. The Beavers got to kick this. Yeah, fourth down. The Beavers got to get a kick a field goal and get a field goal.
Seska, the last time, of course, tried a 37-yarder in almost the same spot, and he missed it just wide to the left. This one will be spotted about the 29-yard line, making it a 39-yarder, almost the same spot.
Absolutely. And again, he needs to knock this through.
True freshman to kick it. Boy, almost blocked, but that kick is up and good. Ryan Seska delivers here to give Oregon State a 34-31 advantage.
We see some fans right there wondering what's going on. The Beavers have put themselves in this predicament, if you will. They've put themselves in a tight game as we're almost to the fourth quarter. The Beavers have not got the wind in the fourth quarter.
Golf's Ryder Cup captain, Ben Crenshaw, goes one-on-one with Chris Myers on tonight's Going Deep. Crenshaw, of course, has lashed out at some Ryder Cup members who want to be paid for their participation. Crenshaw with 19 PGA victories. He's worn the green jacket a couple of times, winning the Masters in 1984 and 1995. It's Going Deep tonight at 9 on Fox Sports Net Northwest. Scott Lynn and Steve Priest and the guys in the black shirts thought it was going to be an easy day. Some of them even talked about the numbers that they were going to put up, statistics. And the coach said, how can they talk like that?
Well, that's the truth. And, you know, kids are kids, Scott. I mean, you got pro athletes who do the same thing. They think they're going to win, and this kind of thing happens. The Beavers are right now in a dogfight, but they're ahead right now. The defense has to step up and stop this real solid wishbone offense.
Anthony Williams is back. Benny Cunningham back as well. And that's going to be down in the end zone. Check that. That was Zareem Walden that was back as well. I'm sorry. There's the scoring drive. Seven plays, 50 yards. A 39-yard field goal by Seska. And it's a 34-31 lead inside the final minute of this third quarter. And look, a new quarterback, J.R. Revere, the sophomore out of LaGrange, Georgia. This guy played in all four playoff games a year ago and in five regular season games. He has skills as well.
Well, Hill hobbled off after his last touchdown, but Revere's the third leading scorer or runner on this team. I can tell you right now, he isn't Hill. He can run it, but he isn't Hill.
And James Allen is back in the game, 34. That's great to see, Steve.
Absolutely. You see, this year, 4 for 5 passing, that's pretty decent.
But he runs for 50 yards a game thus far.
Yeah, he's a good football player. Hill is something really special. Hill is Tim Alexander versus the rest of the option quarterbacks. He's smooth. This guy can do it. There's no question with that. But he doesn't do it as quickly as Hill does.
And now a whistle, and we have come to the end of the third quarter. So, J.R. Revere and the Georgia Southern Eagles have the football and a chance to take the lead when we come back. 15 minutes of football left. Welcome back to Corvallis. The fourth quarter begins. Georgia Southern with the football trailing 34-31 at Oregon State. Georgia Southern, Revere calls his number. He still has it. gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Micah Moore on top of him there, number 27. And down low, that's Jonathan Jackson.
That was really a nice play by Micah Moore. That quarterback has great quicks. He came through. Look at this, Scott. Rushing yards, Oregon State holding themselves in there 200. The other side of the ball, they're supposed to do this. They're 240. That's not a lot for them, total yards. Look at this. You would think this wasn't a game, but part of it's those turnovers. The total offense, the time of possession right here. Dude, the Beavers have played that well. They just aren't winning the game as far as they should be.
And penalties in that first half hurt them desperately. And now a little razzle-dazzle. And this could be a big play. Ant Williams gets the first down. Anthony Williams, wide receiver. They call him Ant because of his size. He's only 5'8", 150. But Ant just made a mountain out of a molehill there.
Well, Paul Johnson said, hey, they just ran it on us. Let's run the same play on them out of the option. Poli is the defensive end. Yeah, 51. He's got to be out there. You know, you got contained. You're a defensive end. You got to stay there. You're deep as the deepest. You keep the guy. You make him come inside if nothing else. Now first down.
And James Allen stayed down on the field for a moment and has been taken off to the sideline, I believe. First down and 10. Option pitch. It was up for grabs for a moment. Peterson hangs on and gets a first down. Are you kidding me? This team is smelling a victory here.
That was a great play by Peterson because it was a lousy pitch. Wow.
Well, again, Steve, coming into this football game, Georgia Southern had fumbled the football seven times this year in two games. Recovered them most of the time. Had only two turnovers in that regard, but you expect to see the ball on the turf a little more in an option.
Well, you do. We sure used to see it on the turf a lot. And it is a system that fumbles the football. As you look at Peterson, 20 for 131, it's a system that fumbles the football if you get hit. And that was a pitch that was actually a forward pass. Should have been a fumble.
And off to the fullback, Peterson again. This is a guy who rushed for nearly 5,000 yards in a high school career. Last year, he had six games where he rushed for 200 yards or more.
Boy, that's amazing. Good football player, very good football player. I'm looking on the sideline for Greg Hill to see what he's doing. He's hobbled on.
Erickson.
Bad knee. You see Coach Erickson on the other side. He was afraid of this game, afraid his kids weren't ready. I don't see Hill anywhere. Maybe he's in the locker room.
Let's see if we can find out what's happened to him. Sitting down on the end of the bench, Steve, as here we can see the play continue, and this is the pitch, and he's still on his feet, pushing hard. And I'm telling you, these guys don't go down. Gerard Freeman stopped by Dennis Weathersby eventually.
Well, the Beavers,
first down.
The Beavers are watching a team that says, hey, we got a chance to win a big game, and they got to suck up on defense and stop these people. You see Hill right there. There's a quarterback now. If he's sitting there like that, I got to believe he's going to play again, Scott. They're shaking his hand, telling him great game, but something's wrong or he'd be in. This J.R. Revere, he's a kid who can play. I don't think he's as nifty as Hill. There's the audible. Let's see what he does.
Option. Well developed. Revere keeps it close to the 20. About a yard shy of the first down. There's Hill, and he does look to be hurting.
He does. He doesn't look good there. He was holding a knee when he came off the field. But Revere's got this team going now. They've come all the way down the field. They put their catch receiver in right here, so you never know what's happening with Chris Johnson in. But, again, 8 yards on first down, advantage offense.
Second down, two at the 21 of Oregon State. Beavers with a three-point lead, but the Eagles have the football. Big pitch. Revere gets the first down anyway. That could have even been more.
It sure could have. That's a situation where Hill, with his quickness and ability to judge what's going on, he may have gone into the end zone. Revere hesitated just a little bit. You watch him. He comes down here. He stops right here. He hesitates. See? Hesitates right there. Jonathan Jackson makes a fine play. If he goes to Jonathan Jackson, then he either makes the pitch and they score outside, or else Jonathan runs away and he runs with the football.
Revere has four touchdown runs this year, including a 20-yarder. This football is on the 18, first and 10. Peterson, the ball carrier, the fullback, busts through for about five or six, and it's the Eagles that are on the drive right here.
Well, you know what the quarterback does in this wishbone. He comes up, he reads whether there are five guys to the right or the left, and that's the way they go. He lets them know whether it's strong right, strong left, and runs that way. Then he reads it as he puts the ball in the belly of the fullback. He decides to keep it or not, depending on what the two guards or two defensive tackles do.
300 yards rushing today for the Georgia Southern Eagles, who are trying to get the go-ahead score here with 11 minutes left in this football game. And it is Peterson inside the five, first and goal. A quick handoff to the fullback. Jonathan Jackson and Isaac White stop him. But right now it's Georgia Southern, 1AA, number one ranked, about to move in front unless the Beavers can catch a break or make some big stops.
Well, you know, Beavers defensively right now have to say, hold them to a field goal. Hold them to a field goal. You hope the fans get in this and start creating some
control of that.
They could be. They could be.
Peterson, a lone setback. Looks like another audible. Rivera, there's movement in the backfield and a flag. Benny Cunningham, one of the slot backs, moved on the right side.
Now that was caused absolutely by Tavita. In the middle, he took a run towards the center and somebody
dead
jumped.
Ball. False start on the offense, 5-yard penalty.
Good job, heads up job. If we see this again, you'll see the middle backer right here, Tavita Moala. See, he took the run right there, and you know what happens? Look at that guy. He's supposed to be blocking him. You know, Scott, that was a pass or something there because the slot back, Cunningham had to get to the middle linebacker to block him. So look for a play pass. Look for Chris Johnson, number seven.
He's wide left.
Trying to beat somebody to the inside. He's coming inside.
First and goal at the nine. Beavers stack him up, and he gets inside the five. Again, the handoff to the first man through, Isaac White. Stops Peterson eventually. But this guy, 5'10", 207 pounds. And he is a guy who broke all the freshman records last year, and he is showing us why here today. It'll be second down and goal at the four. Isaac White, looking at him, senior, one-year letter winner out of Hawaii, and Dennis Erickson looks pained, and we can understand why. He said this is a game in which we have very little to gain except a 3-0 season. They have nothing to lose. They can come in here and win, and even if they lose, they still get a national championship bid. This is Revere. And he is stopped. Bawala grabs on. Beavers pulling at the football, trying to break it loose. They do not. Sean Ball was in there as well, number 55. Third down play coming up. Steve, let me ask you something. First of all, you got to stop them on the third down play. But if they don't get it, do you think Paul Johnson will go for a touchdown or go for the tying field goal?
I think it depends on how far away he is. I think if he's within a yard to 2 yards, he could go for it. That's his chance to win the football game instead of tying it. He doesn't want to go, I don't think, into an overtime. So I think this play is huge. Beavers stop this. They got a prayer.
Going to be a pass. It is knocked into the air.
Wow.
Darnell Robinson.
You have no idea. That is a touchdown. Darnell makes that play, and I believe Darnell has missed the coverage. The back comes out of the backfield, runs right by Darnell. You see him go right there, number three? Look at him. Number three has nobody covering him, and Darnell makes an unbelievable play. Now there's a field goal attempt to tie it up at a crazy angle, I'll tell you.
It's a tough angle. This guy's got a lot of leg. Does he have finesse? He's one for one this year. Made a 57-yarder, his career best, and the second longest in Oregon State Stadium history. Formerly Parker Stadium, now Reese's Stadium. 58-yarder by Chris Mangold back in 82, the longest. But right now, with just under 9 minutes left, Chris Chambers will be attempting a 20-yard field goal from a very strange angle. And a flag, and you know what that is? They're taking the delay to get a little bit better angle.
Yeah, they are. Looks like it to me. I think you're dead right, Scott.
Going to take a 5-yard penalty in order to move it back. Now, the Beavers, can they decline this?
Yes, they can. And if they're smart, they will. They did. Good job.
There you go. And there's Dennis Erickson saying, no, we want to see you kick it at an angle. Thanks.
Now let's see if they do it again and they decline it again. How many can they do like that?
We could be here till next week. Chris Chambers, 12 out of 14 a year ago, 1-for-1 in 1999. The Beavers hoping for a miss. Those fans are. The kick is up. It is good. And with 8 minutes and 50 seconds left here at Racer Stadium in Corvallis, it is Georgia Southern and Oregon State all tied up at 34. Welcome back to Reeser Stadium in Corvallis, Oregon. Scott Lynn and Steve Priest with you, and we have a football game. A much closer game than most people anticipated, maybe even us, as it is tied 34-34 with 8:54 left in regulation. Oregon State about to get the football, but Steve, the point you made, the Beavers did stop them and hold them with a field goal.
Yeah, defense came through. They stopped them in that predicament. Now, Oregon State needs to move something on this kickoff.
Prescott with a big hole. He could go. Robert Prescott, the kicker, forces him out of bounds. Chris Chambers caught him. Big return, Robert Prescott. 63 yards for Robert Prescott, a new career high. And Chris Chambers perhaps saved a touchdown. He might have hurt his shoulder.
Well, he did a good job of making the tackle, but these are great blocks here. As we take a look at the people here. TJ leading it, takes a shot here. Come on, get around, Jay Cookus. No, he cleans up behind it. And now just a good job there by Robert Prescott. Kicker does, Chambers does a great job of stopping a touchdown, that's for sure.
And he tried to strip the football. How do kickers learn to try to go for the strip?
I don't know whether he was trying to strip the football as much as he was trying to get out of the way. No, he was trying to strip the football.
Yeah, right, okay.
Now the Beavers need to score. Good teams take bad situations and take them to their advantage.
Simonton wrapped up, brought down in a hurry by Robert LeBlanc. Now, left tackle.
The Beavers need to do what they do best. Take what this team gives them. If the pass is there, you take it. If the run is there, you take it. You march right down the field.
Steve, in the first two games, the Beavers dominated the second halves to win football games. Here, you can see it's Georgia Southern that has the 10-3 lead.
Well, I'm looking, it's interesting. You got Sean Kittner on. Junior Adams was just in. There are some other people playing right now.
You wonder if it's injuries or if it's the coach sending a message. Sean Kittner with his first catch as an Oregon State Beaver. Well, Kittner, the redshirt freshman out of Kaiser, Oregon. He was a prep All-American, and he makes the catch before he's stopped by Ryan Haddon.
Well, you know, this isn't an easy catch. I'll tell you, Jonathan threw the ball behind him. Watch here. Wide open. Jonathan delivers it behind him. He makes a nice catch. That's a big play as the Beavers move it down to the 22.
Those of you who are regular Fox Sports Net Northwest watchers might remember he was outstanding in leading McNary to a thrilling win over Beaverton in the state championship game here 2 years ago. I had the privilege of calling that game. And there's the handoff to Simonton, spins inside the 20, picked up a 2 or 3. And again, the Georgia Southern defensive front, there's just nothing there for Simonton anymore.
Well, they're playing really tough football. See him right there, Vonselli's, and also I think the other guy, 91,
yeah,
Eugene Phillips. Mm-hmm. They're playing a heck of a football game. They're charged up. The Beavers had them in a situation right there where they had plenty of running room, only 4 or 5 guys in the box. Now there are 5 in the box, and they're very vulnerable in the slot on the right side.
Monchero Jones inside the 10 to about the 6. First and goal, Oregon State.
Monchero makes a nice play. Amani Pacotes does a super job outside of blocking. The Beavers now need to get that ball in there. They got to get a score out of this and get 7 points.
Haddon and Youngblood force him out of bounds, but this is a nice play. And you're right, great block right there.
Look at that block by Percoats. That was just a super job.
First and goal. Percoats goes wide to the right. I'd be surprised if Simonton doesn't get it handed to him here.
Well, inside play looks good.
The play on the far side of the field. Simonton wrapped up in a hurry by Jones and a whole bunch of other guys.
Looks like an offsides one team or the other.
Well, the Beavers are clapping, so it looks like it's against Georgia Southern, and I've really got to think that Paul Johnson's not going to enjoy that call a lot.
Well, you know, it's
half the distance. Still first down.
That was a big play. The Beavers, I see Robert Prescott going off with an injured shoulder right now, but the Beavers had a play called that actually wasn't there. Kenny needed to be inside with that one. They were set up and had two people stand at the end of the line of scrimmage for the bounce out. They're trying to play the bounce and the toss. I think the Beavers go right straight ahead in that situation. Now it'll be different. Short yardage, a lot different now. Now they bounce outside on the right and it's home free.
Simonton, big hole. Touchdown, Oregon State, back in front.
Stand on defense, because I will tell you, you don't want this to go down to a two-point conversion by
trying to stop the option.
Absolutely. You do not want that to happen.
Little pressure right here as Seska must nail this into the sun. Kick down, good. So the extra point is good, and with 6 minutes and 41 seconds left, Ken Simonton and the Beavers are back on top, but this is far from over.
Ooh.
But Oregon State does lead by 7. Six minutes, 41 seconds left here in Corvallis. Oregon State leading Georgia Southern now, 41-34. The number one ranked 1AA team in the nation, the Eagles of Georgia Southern, taking on a Pac-10 team for the first time ever. And they are right there where they want to be in the football game in the fourth quarter. Ken Simonton with another touchdown. Simonton, 3-yard run this time, 5 plays, 37 yards on the drive, 2 minutes. Simonton guaranteed, before the season began, a winning record and a bowl appearance. And to do that, the Beavers quite honestly have to win this football game.
Without a doubt. And you know something, Scott? The Beavers have got to make a defensive stand here. If this is a long drive, takes it down to the last minute or so, you got to believe that Georgia Southern, if they could score, will end up going for two. They want to take their chance then. Good kick, good coverage now, Beavers.
Shreve with it again. Oh, what a big play! Jake Cookus on special teams. Inspiration for Oregon State.
Big play when it was needed. Jake Cookus comes around the block. He sells out on this, folks. This is a great play by Cookus. He's blocked enough that he shouldn't have been in this play, and he just comes screaming around the corner. Watch Jake, he'll come, watch this. Just a nice play. He goes right around the block. Wow. That up back is going to be chewed. He had a chance, and now Beaver fans are back in it, Scott.
The sophomore from Roseburg, Oregon, with a big play on special teams, has the crowd in it. And now Peterson, the ball carrier, might have a first down very close before the Beavers stop him. The whistle blows. Calvin Carlisle comes up from the free safety spot, the first to stop him and wrap him up. And again, Peterson has an answer to everything the Beavers are throwing at him defensively.
Well, I think it is a first down. It is.
Wow. Well, inside 6.5 minutes left, and now Georgia Southern just 7 points down. And look at Peterson's numbers. There were some who questioned whether he could run for 100 yards against a Pac-10 team. He's done that easily. Again, it goes to him, this time nothing. Sean Ball underneath, tripping up the fullback.
Well, the Beavs really need to play these next two plays as they've never played them. They need to stop it here while they still got some field position.
Sean Ball, number 55, 3-year letter winner out of Hawaii. Started all 11 games last year, 6.5 tackles for loss, had 4.5 sacks. Second down and 8 after the 2-yard pickup. Revere chased by Ladarius Jackson, and he goes out of bounds. Collision over on the sidelines. Everybody's all right, I think. J.R. Revere, though, showing that he's a dangerous threat as well.
Well, he is. He is. He's a heck of an athlete, heck of a football player.
Well,
just is not Greg Hill.
You talked about him being an athlete. He is indeed. 4-year letter winner in high school in baseball and football. 3 letters in basketball. Fine player.
Huge play. 3rd and 7. I believe you got to run the option. I don't think you can hand off the fullback, even if they give it to you. Not with Terrence Carroll standing in the middle.
You see Hill standing on the sidelines now. Revere to throw. In trouble. Manning giving chase. James Allen giving chase. He did not get the first down. Allen cut off the angle, and he's short of the first down by about 2 yards.
Boy, I'll tell you, you got to have speed or that's a first down. This kid can fly, but now you got a third and two. You know, this coach didn't come here to lose, so he's going to take it. You watch the replay right here. They were trying to run screen. The Beavers have played the screen again, and Eric Manning puts a good rush on him. Nice block on Eric, but James Allen squares it up, gets him out of bounds. They gave him 2 extra yards there, folks.
Fourth
he was out
down.
Of bounds, bounds on the 31.
Fourth and two. This is the football game. Listen to the crowd in the orange and black and see if the Beavers stop it or not. Not.
Ah.
Peterson, first down. He is something. J.R. Revere says, maybe I'll just keep handing it off to him.
Well, that's the guy you wanted to take the football right there if you're going to stop it. See, Aaron had an inside move right there and vacated. The quarterback read it perfectly. Now, Beavers in a position they just simply got to step up, stop him.
First down and 10 at the 39. How about that, huh? Gambling on fourth down and two. I guess the football game's on the line here with just over 5 minutes left. And now the Beavers say, not now, one, not this time.
One play late.
Yeah, right. Peterson last week carried 22 times for 156 yards and 4 touchdowns against Wolford. He likes his numbers this week against the Pac-10 team just as much.
Well, Eric Manning again playing in there. He is just having a great true freshman season. He's in for Sean Ball right now. Sean looked like he was nicked up a little bit earlier, but again, Beavers got to stand up right here. They won first down there. Now they got to win second down, win third down, and win fourth down.
Hand off to Peterson. He gets about 3. That's his 29th carry of the day. He's up now to 172 yards.
Boy.
Tackled again by Eric Manning.
Isn't his surge incredible? I mean, this is a guy who only weighs 207. You've carried all those times, and he still hits big power each way, and he surges for an extra yard or two each time. Now you got third down. Again, I can't believe with this young quarterback, he's not going to call his own number and not read it for anything but himself to pitch or run.
Well, Steve, I think, you know, 6 yards to go for a first down. This, again, is a two-play situation. They're going to go for it on fourth.
Yeah, you're right. It's a four down.
The pass is incomplete. Up high, intended for Dedrick Parham, who's made some big catches today, but he didn't get that one as the pass was well overthrown.
Well, here it is. Ball game right here. Could be the ball game.
The word we get about Greg Hill, the starting quarterback, is he has calf cramps and cannot push off right now. So,
well, you know, Scott, I'm looking at this. They may be punting.
And I think they are. Yep. Well, Chambers is in to do the punting. And it's fourth and 6. They do have all 3 timeouts, yep. Steve. So with 3 minutes and 40 seconds left, they still have a chance to get the football back. And now the Beavers simply have to execute. T.J. Hushmanzada has to catch this punt, even if it means a punt. Oh, there's a snap problem. Chambers is going to chase it down. And now he's going to be fumble football. The Beavers have it. Touchdown, Oregon State. Touchdown, Beavers. Woo. Darnell Robinson for the second week in a row scores a touchdown.
Oh, baby. This is a guy who was hurt in the first quarter, came off the field. We talked about him, how he earned the starting job last week, Scott. I know how to score touchdowns. Wow, what a defensive play.
And that, folks, is huge. And you see the kicker is down right there. That's Chambers.
Well, you know, Scott, the special teams of Oregon State, well, there's Darnell right there, 2 weeks in a row. Special teams of Oregon State gave up a cheapie early on. This game wouldn't have been close early on without that. Now they came through at the end thanks to a bad snap. Wasn't that bad of a snap. The kicker just drops it. If we see this, it goes right through his hands. It goes right through his legs. He catches that ball. You see this? Now look at all the Beavers back there. Great speed right there. That's Ladaris, a defensive end, running like a linebacker. And you got 4 or 5 Beavers.
Well, and I mentioned this earlier, Darnell Robinson knows what it feels like to score a touchdown. He came to Oregon State as an option quarterback, so he says, hey, no big deal. But, man, it's a big deal right now.
Oh, boy, is it.
And Chambers knows that that is a crucial play in this football game. Not all his fault. But you have to wonder, Steve, you know, you're in a situation there. You're down seven. You really can't take the safety.
No,
can't. You really can't.
Well, you know, I don't think he thought about that a bit. Quite frankly, he's walking off the field now with a hurt shoulder, and that shocks me. He's a guy that's an upperclassman in a big game like this. If they can walk with their legs, I'm surprised he's leaving the field.
Well, there's a big point after as it gives Oregon State a full 14-point lead with just inside 3.5 minutes left. Those fans in the orange and black breathing just a little easier now. Thank you. Just under 3.5 minutes remaining, and the rally squad is all smiles now. The signs of nervousness gone, and here's the big play, the snap right through his hands.
Boy.
Chris Chambers now knows he's in trouble, and I wondered, you know, why not run out of the end zone and take just a two-pointer? But it is. It makes it a nine-point game, two-possession game. You really can't do that.
I agree with you, Scott. I think if you're thinking and have time to analyze it, you'd rather do that than have a touchdown. But watch this run.
Oh, and he ran into his own guy. And again, we're talking Anthony Williams, who had a pretty good return earlier.
Yeah.
But complete that thought, Steve, because I really thought, and you made the point, that maybe they would go on fourth down rather than punt it away.
Well, let's first of all finish the safety issue.
Okay.
If you're thinking about it, you absolutely are better off. As you look at the summary, Symington, 175 yards, 271 for Jonathan again. Peterson, 172. Two pretty good running backs running the ball today as you look at the rushing between the two teams. But if you're talking about a safety, if you think about it, you got to take the 2 points. Otherwise, you're giving Oregon State either the touchdown like they did or the ball on the 10-yard line. So, you know, you're expecting a kid on the fly to think about that.
Yeah.
He isn't going to. You know, there's just
and
no
he's
question.
Panicked because the ball went right through his hands, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
He's shattered. Well, the other issue is probably just as important that you were bringing up is the fourth down and six. With Greg Hill in the game, I believe that Coach Johnson goes for that. Greg is just that much better than J.R. Rivera.
What a disappointment this will be for Paul Johnson, but I know he'll be very proud of his players when this thing is all over. And don't go away because it's not over yet. I should make that addendum to this. That pass is complete to Parham again.
Well, you know, these guys were 60-40, if you can believe it. Oregon State's coaches on defense said, you know, this is a team that has all this discussion about their wishbone, but they've been about 60-40 so far in the films that we've seen from last year. The Beavers didn't have much good film this year because they've been watching wishbone teams versus wishbone teams.
Chris Johnson, the key receiver, goes wide to the left side, far and wide right. Going to throw a little bit. Oh, way up and over Johnson. Great pressure by Tavita Malala as he ends up on top of the quarterback, Revere.
Well, and you know, that's a good pass, and Dennis Weathersby's taking that one in for a touchdown. Great job. It's hard to run a little swing screen like that when you've got people playing bump and run. They just don't have a positive pass offense that knows what to do in that situation. You got to check it off and go somewhere else with it.
You might wonder how Oregon State ended up playing a Division I AA team on their schedule, and that's Oregon State added this game when San Jose State pulled out to play Colorado for more money. OSU Athletic Director Mitch Barnhart called Georgia Southern Athletic Director Sam Baker, whom he knew from their days at the U of O back in 83. They set up this game. So they're playing a Pac-10 team for the first time ever as Revere, 1 yard shy of the first down. He ran out of bounds.
Yeah. Some kind of move to stand that guy up so you can get the extra yard. It was there for the taking. Now they're in a third down situation where they got to get a first.
Georgia Southern playing a Pac-10 team for the first time, guaranteed over $200,000, which is a big payday for the school. But they really came in here thinking we might be able to get a win, and right now they're still in the football game as Revere heads out of bounds, and now probably a flag. Yeah. Terrence Carroll came to push him out of bounds, and the official ruled that he was already out. And Carroll says he still had a foot in when I leaped at him.
That's a situation where an official on the sideline got talked into a call.
Well, look whose bench he's in front of.
Yeah, absolutely. He got talked into a call here. Let's see where Terrence makes the hit. Terrence has something to say here. He's got him right there. He's a hold of him. He lets go of him. Folks, that's ridiculous. There, Paul Johnson screaming right there, and the official behind the play makes the call. Shouldn't have been. Terrence Carroll was right. Dennis Erickson's got something to say about it, but Beavers, you can't give up a quick touchdown. You got to make them earn it.
Way too much time with 2:44 left, and Georgia Southern with three timeouts remaining.
Terrence Gray in at the left corner, place of Keith Hayward Johnson.
Revere to throw, under pressure, throws it up for grabs. Tipped up in the air, the Beavers cannot come away with it. Terrence Gray, number 7, almost got it on the rebound.
Off from the other side,
Weathersby
and Terrence Carroll had it. Kind of scary there for a minute with the way Parham goes up in the air and his big frame. I thought, oh, baby. Sets his feet real well, lets it go. Now look at this, Parham's nice job by Weathersby, wow.
And a pretty good effort there by Oregon State.
Weathersby's played real well this season as far as pass coverage is concerned. He's a guy that right now has to suck it up because he's playing man-on-man, bump and run every play.
Second and 10, Revere to throw. Throws it.
No way.
Oh, they give it to him.
The pass
is complete to Chris Johnson.
That bounced all the way there. Now the official behind this play, he can see it bounces. Field judge, he can see that bounced in there.
Look at Dennis check the clock. You see that? Look right up to the scoreboard clock.
I think officials should take some kind of a physical test so they can at least move and run.
The replay shown here on the big stadium scoreboard, and Dennis Erickson just saw that, and he is furious.
This isn't close. Watch this. Watch this, folks. The ball is going to go. It's bouncing on the ground. It hits the ground.
Hits him in the knee.
No question about it. The official knows it. He can make the call. He's just too lazy and sitting back there 15 yards, taking his time.
Ladarius Jackson from behind catches Revere. There's some of the speed that we know that Ladarius Jackson has. Well, the game is not over.
Everyone
needs to work it to its conclusion, including those guys on the field, right?
I'll tell you, they score right here, they get an onside kick. We're back exactly in the same situation where we were. Right now, they got three wides, they're going to throw the football.
Lobbing it up for Johnson. He kind of pushed off, got away with it. First and goal at the one.
Unbelievable.
Chris Johnson, who had two touchdown catches a week ago, a 27-yarder and a 57-yarder, almost got one here. Minute 39 remaining, first and goal at the one, and Georgia Southern with a chance to pull within a touchdown.
Let's take a look.
He pushed off, Steve.
Let's see whether there's a push. There's absolutely a push, folks. And that's the same official. The field judge is standing right next to him and not doing diddly squat.
Touchdown! The call came very late from the linesman, but it is a touchdown. Georgia Southern, now with a point after, will be within 7 points. And a minute 33 left. Paul Johnson.
Hey, and Scott, just so we know right here, here's the place they go for 2 points because they got a new kicker in. Right here, if you're a coach, this is where you go for the points.
And
right
this is
here.
Attempted a kick here, getting his first chance to try a point after. They hope to redshirt him, Steve. I was told that just before the game, but he's in here now because of the injury to the regular kicker. He kicks it up and through, and he swallows real hard right now, and he's got to go kick off and try the onside kick. Don't go away, people. It's not over yet.
And three timeouts still for Georgia Southern.
There's J.R. Revere, who scored the touchdown. 1 yard run on the keeper, 9 plays, 85 yards, only a minute 40. So that with a minute 33 left, the Georgia Southern Eagles are back within 7 points of Oregon State here in Corvallis. Scott Lynn and Steve Priest with you, and look for the onside kick here.
And you know, Scott, it's interesting that the possession is now in the favor of Georgia Southern. The Beavers have still got a big goal offense lead, but.
Here comes the onside kick. Hands team, Roddy Tompkins, right there in the front row.
Huge.
Makes the recovery of the onside kick.
Senior captain makes as big a catch, if you will, as he's made all season. Right there, Roddy makes that play, huge play.
Now you simply cannot just fall on the football either, Steve.
Yep, good kick, it bounces It didn't even, yeah, bounced once early, and then Roddy makes the big play. Beavers can't fall on the football, as you said, Scott. They got to go down the field because you need a first down. Three timeouts, you got to get some yardage on first down.
Dennis Erickson knew his team. Maybe took this team a little lightly. Mm-hmm. Georgia Southern, the number one ranked 1AA team in the nation, has made it a game. Something special for them. Simonton, the ball carrier, two hands on the football, bulls his way forward for two and a half yards. Second down, and I know that Georgia Southern will take a timeout coming up here momentarily, and I think they have, as a matter of fact, with 1:27 left on the scoreboard clock here at Reser Stadium. There's Ken Simonton, who's had another great, great game. You know, tomorrow night at 7 on Fox Sports Net Northwest tonight, highlights of today's Seahawks-Bears game. You can catch up with Washington Husky head football coach Rick Neuheisel and take a walk down Press Row with Northwest media members, plus the Northwest sporting news of the day. Tomorrow night at 7 on Fox Sports Net Northwest. Scott Lynch, Steve Priest with you. These fans, some of them, I think I still see their fingers crossed out there, hoping for good stuff to happen.
Well, you know, you got to get a first down. You just have to get a first down. This team has a chance to win it if they somehow get the football. You're holding on the football, but you got to get a first down. Oregon State going with two tight ends, which doesn't spread the field.
Here's Oregon State's schedule the next month. A bye week next week to get ready for the Pac-10 opener at USC, then home against Washington, and then at Stanford. So it's going to be a tough test, but you got to like that bye week before the Pac-10 opener.
You sure do, and that's going to get the Beavers healthy. But I tell you, they need to get themselves healthy right now. Right now.
Simonton, the ball carrier. You can expect it to go to him time and again. Hand off Simonton. Ducks down. Gets to the 45 of Georgia Southern, and a quick timeout once again. And a minute 22 left on the scoreboard clock. So they're very, very quickly getting the timeouts called, and the Beavers, pure and simple, are going to have to get a first down, as you said, Steve.
Well, and you know, I'm surprised they're still using two tight ends. I'd get DJ. DJ's in, I'd get Montero back in. Get yourself at least three wides in that formation. Here they come.
All right, and of course, coming up next, it's the Battle of the Palouse. The Washington State Cougars clash with the Idaho Vandals in Martin Stadium. They're playing in Martin Stadium, but the Cougars are the away team. Figure that out. That's a tough road game playing on your home turf. That's coming up next on Fox Sports Net Northwest. Well, the Beavers trying to start 3-0 for the first time since 1967 have found it a very difficult thing to do. It's the fifth time that they would be 3-0 since 1939. That's 60 seasons. But there's still a long way to go in this one, in that the Beavers must go 5 yards for a first. I think it was Roddy Tompkins' mom, wasn't it? Holding up the sign there.
Well, you know, you look at this.
Big play. Simonton stopped. The Beavers will have to punt the football as timeout is called with a minute 16 left. Don't go anywhere. We're right. Getting about 3-0 for right now. We've got a little ways to go here.
That's absolutely for sure. And now let's just think about this. Last week, the Beavers have a kick blocked. Remember that. And the Beavers are in a position where right now, they got to block first, sew it up blocking, and then Mike Fessler has to put the ball somewhere to give the Beavers field position. Don't just kick it out of the end zone, Mike. Put it down there somewhere inside the 20.
Anthony Williams is back, standing on his 10-yard line. Mike Fessler into punt. Tim Murdoch, the snapper. A walk-on who has been recruited to do the snapping here for this team. He's been up and down, but the Beavers need a good one right here. It's right into the hands of Fessler. The punt is to Williams. He comes up and takes it on the 19. Beavers giving chase. Samuel Gage with the stick.
Well, folks, defense has got to have a play right here. Defense has got to have the kind of play that you look they're going to be thrown at. See if they're in a zone, see whether they play zone, see whether they play a little tougher. My guess is we'll see some two deep and three deep zone here because the idea is a field goal doesn't hurt you.
Paul Johnson, who says, hey, we want to play a Division 1A team every year. Yeah, this is a money game. It won't make or break our season. We could still play for the 1AA title, but man, if we could win, it would be special. Revere throws complete to Chris Johnson. Kept in bounds.
Wow.
Now the clock will stop while they move the chains, but forward progress was ruled before he was pushed out of bounds. So once the ball is set, they'll wind up the clock again.
Yeah. And I'll tell you, Beavers, you better stop them, because this is going to be a chance for a two-point conversion if they score with no time on the clock.
With the timer, put 2 seconds back on the clock. 59 seconds.
And every second could make a difference here.
Well, the fans need to get into this. They're out of timeouts now, aren't they?
Out of timeouts. The Beavers have three remaining. Revere has not thrown a touchdown pass this year, nor has he been intercepted in his limited time.
Well, you know, sooner or later, Peterson's got to get the ball just to keep people honest.
Revere, the throw. Got a guy open, complete. Unbelievable what's happening here in Corvallis as Parham with another big catch. First down, out of bounds. Clock stops, 51 seconds to play.
Now, this is a situation where the Beavers are playing zone. The up guy in the zone, in that case, Calvin Carlisle, he's got to see that there's nothing coming into his side. Not, don't suck up on that back in the flat, Peterson, like he did. You got to keep going depth and take away the out on that. You pretty well know they're going out, so you can play it to some degree if you're up in the zone. You can't if you're deep in the zone.
Paul Johnson, the head coach of the Georgia Southern Eagles, with his team trying to come down and tie it. The pass is almost intercepted by Keith Hayward Johnson. Intended for Parham, but thrown away. Second down play coming up. The ball at the 45-yard line of Oregon State here at the end of regulation. 45 seconds left.
You know, these guys aren't running tough patterns. They're just, you know, it's a zone coverage. They're just going, turning around and catching the football. And, you know, that's great. I look to see Oregon State continue to do it. You got to make them earn every bit of it.
Paul Johnson, National Coach of the Year a year ago, 1AA. Revere to throw. Over the middle, incomplete.
Nice
looking
play.
Yeah, that was a very nice play. The pass intended for Sherrard Freeman. He thought there might have been contact. Quite honestly, I didn't think so.
No.
But, hey, you got to try it at that point. Paul Johnson out on the field, talking to his quarterback, J.R. Revere, on in relief of Greg Hill, who went out with the cramps.
Is that what it was, cramps? Wow.
Cramped calf. He's actually been standing on the sidelines the last couple of series. But there is Johnson, whose team is very much still in the football game. No timeouts, though. And on third down and 10, this is a big play.
Watch screen here. Watch out for screen. They haven't gotten Peterson involved.
Revere to throw, and it is caught, and it is a first down for Georgia Southern. Chris Johnson, the playmaker. Boy, Dave Johnson and his team doing the Southern Conference proud.
Nice throw here. Puts it right on the money. Nice catch. Oh, boy. Was he offended or not? Nice catch. And now the Beavers, now they got to play a lot tougher. Can't give them anything.
Revere to throw again. Over the middle, incomplete. Intended for number 36, Benny Cunningham. The clock stops with 31 seconds left.
Boy, if I were these Georgia Southern quarterbacks, I would be looking for the two big wide receivers going down the middle. They've made about four adjustment catches, pushing away from people. I mean, I think you got to go down there and go to those guys instead of coming across the middle. They're one-on-one outside, Johnson and Parham. They're both big.
Second down, 10. Revere looking. Under pressure. Throws it. And they're going to say it's a catch.
No way.
It's a catch and a first down at the 22-yard line.
You have got to be kidding me.
The line judge with the call, Blake Lozo, says it's in. Couldn't tell from our angle.
Maybe he
had a foot down.
Boy, this is a great job by Revere. He came from out of bounds, Scott. He came from out of bounds. He'd already been out of bounds.
So now first down and 10, the ball at the 22, 23 seconds left. I'll tell you, the Beavers win the football game with a sack right here.
Absolutely.
But Georgia Southern is on the march. Revere says, it's not midnight, but I'm going for the ride. Oh, it's incomplete.
Wow.
Chris Johnson was open,
baby,
in the end zone. There had been contact with Keith Hayward Johnson. No flags, no catch, incomplete, 18 seconds left.
Of all times to get a drop down on a corner, wow. If that ball's anywhere near a decent pass, that's a stand-up touchdown. You think coach has got his two-point play ready to go?
I would think so.
You've got no choice now. You don't want to be kicking against the guy that had the kick. Another, go for everything.
You're absolutely right. Another nice drive by Georgia Southern. Revere looking towards the end zone. Now he's running. Oh, the Beavers! Manning with the tackle. This might do it unless they can get to the line of scrimmage in a hurry. Time is ticking down. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, 5 seconds, four. They're going to get the clock stopped. Maybe. Yes, the spike with 1 second left on the scoreboard clock.
Boy. Those 2 seconds earlier, Scott, unbelievable. 2 seconds were put back on the clock. The game would be over right here.
And a flag down? Yes, indeed. On the far sideline, a
illegal
flag on the play.
On the offense.
Well, wait a minute.
5 yard penalty.
This isn't like the pros. You can, I guess, have a penalty like that in the last minute without losing it.
So the Beavers will push it back 5 yards. It'll be at the 25, one play. Georgia Southern shooting for the end zone. Listen to the crowd, see if the Beavers stop it or if they get it done. Under pressure, Revere throws it up for grabs, incomplete. It's over, the Beavers prevail. Tavita Balala and Sean Ball.
Wow, what a game.
And the crowd pours onto the field here at Reser Stadium as Dennis Erickson's team goes 3-0, but it was never easy.
Wow, that was a great effort right there by Ladaris. The people, Tavita, who came in at the end and made the play when they have to play it. And you know, we can talk all we want about how they didn't get ready, didn't do a lot of things, but they won the football game when they had to.
And let's go back to the Magnolia moment, our play of the game, the fumbled punt snap that leads to a Beaver touchdown, and I mean leads right now to a Beaver touchdown. Darnell Robinson ends up with it.
Well, this is the win right here, Scott. I mean, this is the whole ball game, it turns out. I wouldn't have said it then, but it certainly is the whole football game as we see it now.
Our Magnolia moment, our play of the game, Darnell Robinson, that was the difference. What proved to be the game-winning touchdown. Dennis Erickson's team 3-0. A week off before they play the Pac-10 opener at USC. Look at the crowd and a happy bunch of Beaver fans. So for Steve Priest, this is Scott Lynn saying so long from Reser Stadium, where the final score is Oregon State 48, Georgia Southern 41. Don't miss the Beavers' next game Sunday, October 3rd at 11 a.m. against the USC Trojans. You've been watching Beaver football on Fox Sports Net Northwest. Stay tuned. Coming up next, more Northwest College football, Washington State at Idaho.